Guys, we just had some technical issues there.
It should be still
As
the same
long
thing, right?
with their stream is also having a lot of technical issues. We don't know exactly what the issue is right now, but they seem to be having a long tech pause. It definitely isn't a regular pause, especially at this point. I guess you guys already know that, though. I assume you're not stupid. It looks like they're getting back into it. Okay, so we'll see if we can jump into the stream as fast as possible.
If the chat's still connected to this one, because it's still going on the old stream.
I don't know. But
just reconnect the app then.
That's not the one we wanted. Why is it?
We just start it again then.
We need to get rid of it first. That's what I'm trying to do. Okay. Okay, let's not have the casters on. Thank you. Okay, welcome back to the stream.
You can stop the chat, remember?
I'll get the app up. Welcome back to the stream. So we're kicking it off with Winstrike run round up, so they won the pistol round quite clearly. Here's Alu. He might get some contact here. And he does. He gets a very nice headshot right there on a World Edit. The World Edit had the AWP as well. So that's going to be a costly mistake for him.
There we go.
So Boomich and I don't know what that guy is. Norman are trying to take long, along with and Alu's causing a lot of issues here, doing a bit of extra damage.
Well, fuck.
Alexi B doing even more. Annex 7 getting two more kills. This might be an eco win for him.
Oh shit! Nice shot there. Fuck.
So Kev gets a nice shot on Alu, who's been causing a lot of issues with this Winstrike take of long. But this might still be an ENCE round to lose. They still have the player advantage. But
almost down to Goblin, and he's down.
He takes one down.
Well, Boomich, he's pretty low health
just
himself,
gets
though.
Two. X7 and Boomich, the last ones. But Boomich manages to get the last kill. Very nice from Boomich there.
Winstrike wins.
So that was a pretty basic take of long, which kind of went very wrong after Alu got that first headshot on the pit guy, which is this going to be an expensive round for Winstrike coming into the next round, but it shouldn't be too big of an issue since Ents are going to have to full save on this round. So he's going for a cheeky pick in mid. He misses that shot, but he sees two cross. A lot of good info. There's currently three
going
players.
In for smoke, making sure no one comes in through there. It's a typical CS tactic.
Yeah. On long, they were just taking it so the other team could not. But it seems like there is only one guy on A site, and they have taken short control. Winstrike. They mollied off the corner that someone could be hiding in, but they can't anymore.
Also, the short stairs and above seems pretty quiet.
Yep. So we're getting some players rotate onto A site now from long, as you can see on the minimap there.
Oh, there we go.
And this should be a pretty comprehensive take from Winstrike.
Oh, he just
catches
him from the corner. Just for a little cheeky shot.
But he misses. And
flashed.
This should be an easy take here for Winstrike.
Oh, no, didn't land that shot.
He manages to get... Alexi B gets one kill. Norbert's still pushing, and he manages to get the kill, but they're getting a lot of damage down. They've got at least two players on very low health, but he comes in, Boomich, and gets two kills.
We only won loss as well. That was pretty swift.
Pretty swift take, but there was two players on very low health. If Ence had managed to capitalize on that would have been very bad for Winstrike.
Yeah, I was going to say, with only one loss... They made it through that round. Pretty lucky.
Yeah, that was a pretty, I think, I don't know what the word is, an edged round for Winstrike there. They should have been able to comprehensively take that a bit easier.
Yeah.
His Kiev's
so
coming
in
on,
first,
but they have long
like...
control. Maybe Ence
just
didn't
managed
hear
to slip round
but
the
he
corner.
Managed to get round, but two
I'll say
very
that was
swift
an
kills.
Incredibly risky move. Yes,
Alexi
bigger.
B gets two kills here, and Ariel got one other. This should be an easy shutdown. It's an easy shutdown.
I'll say he had some. The other player had some big old cojones to pull off that move.
Yeah, I know, right? But he didn't pull it off anyway.
No, not just right.
And
now, catch him.
Now Ence have got the bomb down on long, as you can see on the mini.
Oh yeah,
and
there's only two left,
and they're crossing. Alu should be able to get at least one of these players as they cross short. But this is a very risky move from Winstrike, but Norbit gets two. Wow, and Boomich gets the other on Alu. Sergei might be able to get one here, and that's a very nice shot from Sergei with the auto sniper.
3-on-1, they quickly level the playing field with that one, it's pretty... still.
Oh my god, Boomich almost getting him there, but obviously you're not going to challenge an auto sniper and win like that. So that was a pretty nice shutdown from the long take from ENCE there. They got three kills straight away. Mm-hmm. The guy who pushed into the pit area, obviously, it was a ballsy play. Didn't pull it off, though. He got pretty ruined.
Again, very risky. I can understand trying to take the risk because they were doing well the last few rounds, but ENCE managed to get back in control.
Yeah, it was a nice take from ENCE on the long side. So we got it seems like it's going to be a B rush from... Oh no, they're going into under to take mid. So Winstrike currently taking mid, and we've obviously...
Oh, here we go. Already got the first sight. Then again, now pretty scattered.
Sergei just trying to get some kills with the smokes. That's a lot of damage from that nade he just threw. Oh, and he's
down.
He misses that shot. You shouldn't be missing shots like that. But Alexi
B... Also, he had the scopes right on him. Perfect time to get a shot.
Alexi B just comes in and shuts that down.
And they're one down already.
Norbert's managed to sneak in here. He might be able to get a quick couple kills. Nah, he's made noise now. They know where he is. He's got the auto, though. And he threw it out of the map. Okay, that's a justified move. The auto is a very expensive weapon. They're not going to be rebuying that anytime soon.
Yeah.
And he gets swiftly taken out when he peaks.
Mm-hmm.
Very good round. Another good round from ENCE there on Dust 2.
ENCE trying to pick things back up.
After the little pause and losing three rounds in a row. And they have been doing it pretty swiftly.
Mm. Trying to take back control of the game. Make sure that they're in power.
Yep, make sure they... Well, in my opinion, ENCE are the superior team here. They're just overall a better team. I know you wouldn't know a huge amount about that because you're not a big Counter-Strike guy. But it's true. ENCE are a much better team than Winstrike. But they have been doing very well at this major so far.
Well, like you said earlier, that the round that we got into after the technical pause, which Winstrike won, they were kind of edging it a little bit. A lot of them were on low health. And ENCE could have taken hold of that, but Winstrike managed to just pull through.
Yeah, it was basically just the difference of weapons there. Norbert might be able to cause a couple issues in CT, and he does get one kill, as I call that.
Yeah.
One very clean headshot. Sadly, we didn't get to see it, but... Wow. Jeez. Okay, so we got Norbert here, again, causing issues. Going to come B, because I think they've got to read that there is only one player currently playing on B site, and they would be right.
Oh, shit.
But he throws it. Oh, my God. A very nice shot.
Nice.
From Norbert again. Two in a row. Alexi B could shut this down here.
That was a clean-ass eagle shot, though. Fuck.
Alexi B gets some tag damage. He can't peek Norbert here. Norbert might peek him. But this is just going to be, I think... Unless Ariel gets this kill here, I think they're just going to save. And he does. And Norbert...
I'll say he had the perfect chance on
top
of the crate.
He gets a kill on Alu there. Ariel... Oh, Alexi B getting two there. This is ENCE's round to lose now. And they do. They just shut him down. And that's another round for ENCE. But that was a very hairy one right at the
Especially
end.
Especially that guy on the crate. He had the perfect chance to get him.
Yeah.
Only had a pistol, though, which is understandable.
Yeah, and he was getting pushed from two angles. So it can make your aim go off a little bit. There's obviously a lot of stress in that situation.
Mm.
I want you to carry it. I really need a WAS.
Sure. I'll just try to carry it.
Luckily, we got a pause.
Yeah, boy.
What a time. Actually, I want to check.
The timeout's 20 seconds.
Actually, I want to check something. Yeah, I thought we had desktop audio muted.
There we go, good.
Just say words.
CSGO's frozen.
Yeah, it will be for a second.
Nice. Love you, CS. Proud of you.
Every time you tap in, it always has issues like that.
Yeah, it does have times that. Okay, here we go. Back of the game. On a pause. Giving you the drops at the very moment.
They're probably just doing a tactical pause there.
Yeah, probably. And any minute now. Countdown has stopped. but we haven't moved off yet.
Okay.
But here we go, so 10.
I'm back. So that tactical pause was probably called from Winstrike there to try and get an idea of how to get back into this and stop the momentum of Ence's obviously three-round win streak.
Mm-hmm.
It looks like X7 got tagged through the door there, and Norbert took a little bit of damage from that nade. And that's Ence's
outside door. Going there with another nade again.
Yeah, seeing if he can get an extra bit of chip damage, but obviously Windstrike have backed off from there, Nan.
Mm-hmm.
So it looks like they're just trying to go for a normal default here to get some control of the map. Everyone on on Ence's side is just playing it pretty passively. They don't want to lose anyone too early.
Nope.
World Edit is going for a peek on someone's head here, but
I've already smoked that area, so he ain't going to be getting that too some soon.
No. And yes. I think he just dropped off to the main site. Alu is taking a little peek into mid to see if he can get a kill.
For the door. There is. Oh!
They both miss each other there.
Only a sliver, though. It's a sliver of image.
Yeah. It's
a very
tight angle, that one.
It was a risk. It wasn't even a risky shot. They both know they're out there.
Yeah.
But it was.
This is a risky shot. Alu gets the first one. Very, very well played from Alu there.
Mm.
And obviously he knew his teammates would follow him up. And Alu again. Alu's getting some very nice shots in here, and he knows where Boomich is.
Yeah, he knows Zabe. He's revealed his spot.
And he's throwing a Mori to force him out. Boomich is getting some nice kills still.
If he waited there a bit longer, I reckon he could have tapped the other.
Oh my god, Alu's just fucking wrecking them right now.
He had the perfect chance to be taken down.
Oh my god, Alu just got a 4K.
Yeah, dude. Jesus
wow.
Fucking Christ.
Did you see that flick onto the guy down along?
Yeah, he was getting hit as well. Alu could have been down and out, but he just flicked around and got him.
That was very nice.
And he was
only
with 45 health, though.
I know.
He got him down, but if only he got that headshot, Alu would have been gone, because Alu was fucking wrecking kids, dude.
Alu literally drops a 4K in that
and
round.
And now Ence takes lead by only one round, but they are taking back control. Alu's fucking going. He just had that round in the palm of his hand.
Oh my god, Alu again getting a very quick
kill. Alu's
getting
aggressive now. He's trying to be dominant now. Oof.
This must be demoralizing if you're Winstrike right now. After having
definitely.
That strong start, and now Alu just comes in with the 4K. And
especially,
had so
Alu definitely gained. Because he just went in there right now. He was getting aggressive.
Yeah, true. Alu again. Oh, he misses that third. Oh my god, Alu. Just calm down, son. Getting a 3K there. And Norbert again, probably just counting his fucking minutes as he tries to survive.
He's almost caught by Alu as well. He's going round.
He should be taking
he's not gonna,
by
yeah.
here.
He wasn't going to win that
no,
one.
I mean, Lexi B. And Lexi B takes him out nice and swiftly there. So that was a good round from Ence again. It was an anti half buy, and it was a pretty easy round for them to take. But okay, Boomich hasn't bought yet, but no, this should just be a normal buy round for both of them. They both have full utility, so they can use all the nades they want. World Edit won't get a kill here because they smoked it off very intelligently.
I mean, he tried, but so it was gonna be a
ooh, Sergey. So
unlikely shot to begin with.
Okay, Alexi B gets a nice kill there. Ooh, Sergey misses a shot there, but he manages to get the follow-up. And Norbert might get taken out.
He's on very low health. If he can make it out.
Yeah, Norbert got killed by the nade there. Oh, look out. That was a very swift round from...
Ooh, 3-6.
Yeah. Okay, so six rounds in a row.
Yeah.
That is very demoralizing if you're Winstrike right now.
Yeah, definitely. When he had a strong start, starting to get a bit lucky, but now Ence taking back the game, taking control.
Taking back control of the game. Seemingly pretty easily, especially in that round, they didn't even lose one player.
No, they had... That was pretty quick as well. Very quick.
Yeah, very swift.
Mm.
And just pretty easy kills from everyone there. Mm. Like, it looked like... I think it was a B split, but they couldn't get through mid, and as soon as that happened, they just lost their entire team.
Yeah.
And this is just a save, a half buy from Winstrike here. Nothing too impressive, of course. They'll... Ooh, and World Edit gets an AK there, a hero AK. I don't know why he does that.
He's back at it with the sniper. He's going to smoke off this area.
So he can peek in the lower area. But Winstrike are taking short.
He backs
right
off.
Now.
Could,
oh my god,
there.
Look at that damage from that nade that Sergei just threw.
They were very clustered
and
together,
the molly.
Though.
Oh my, that's...
I mean, from the smoke, you already knew they were there. I mean, you couldn't entirely tell, but you knew they had been there. And those were some good nades.
Yeah, very, very impressive nade damage from Ence there.
And it was a lucky throw, but damn.
I think it's just knowledge of the game.
Mm.
Just doing
it. It's general game sense saying that they would be there. And there was nothing on there to get enough damage.
And they molly that off to do even more damage with the nade. But Norbert just goes and hides in the smoke. Clever idea. But
they missed one of the
smokes. Oh, Alexi B, nice kill there. He doesn't realize that the
low, there's fucking Alu here.
And he does get the kill on the lower one. And it's all alone. Oh, he gets a nice headshot
there. Takes him out. Will Alu get ult?
Alu trying to jump shot. World Edit's just very scared here because he's being watched from all angles, and that's a nice shot from Ariel just to finish him off there.
Yeah. And only one loss. Ents is going hard.
Very hard. Very nice.
Very nice. Next match.
Next meme. Look at Alexi B, 16 kills, just carrying with Alu on second there with a good 12.
Mm.
And World Edit, well, Waylander on... Yikes. Zero kills for Waylander.
World Edit also on 9.
World Edit, yeah. He's
trying to go for those cheeky shots again.
Oh, and
it costs him
just
dearly.
Takes his head from his shoulders. Alu goes for a cheeky peek. He might have overextended here.
Mm.
But Sergei's here to clean him up, and Alu gets the kill anyway on 4 HP. You would be kicking yourself if you were fucking Norbert there.
Oh, definitely.
Alexi B holding the close angle. He might be able to get a kill if they come around the corner, but it looks like they're going to be doing a B hit or a mid split. No, a B hit here. Okay, because Kiev is just in the long area, but he's just going to be dropping off here. He doesn't want to lose his life too quickly. Waylander's managed to get into this area, but they are watching this area.
He's got like one moving down. It's like, actually, no, he's just keeping.
Okay, they do know these players.
Oh, I reckon I reckon he thinks he can get a cheeky, and he does as well.
Very nice from Waylander there to get that headshot with the AWP. X7 can just completely shut this down though, and he will by the looks of it.
Oh, he's been flashed.
The next one's upper.
He's down.
This could be a difficult take for Ents. But Alu just comes in with another kill, and Bubic is all left alone in a 1v3 situation. He could do it, but he's got players from every angle.
It's not looking good. He's got the bomb down to try and put some pressure on, but I don't. Oh, here we go. They're moving up slowly.
So.
He's cornered.
They're going to wait for the right timing, and then they're going to push together, I believe.
Mm.
So Ariel here is going to push in after that flash.
Oh,
and
he's down.
Very
so nice. Close, though. He could have had Ariel, definitely.
Yeah.
Only on 4 health, but it's too late now. He's already disarmed the bomb. Ents wins again.
I think that would have been a hard round for Bumic to win in either. Like the guy was coming from B main there to come and shoot him in the side.
Yeah,
so.
I mean, he's one lucky fucker if he did win it.
Yeah. So, that 1v3 was very difficult for him.
The odds were against him.
Definitely were. So, here's another full buy. Look at all the orgs and orps. So, full scoped weapons for Ents here.
Yeah.
So, they are going for control.
World Edit always going for those cheeky shots. But it seems like Ents are, you know, he's been doing it one too many rounds at the beginning of every round, so he kind of know his ways.
Okay, they threw the Xbox smoke there, so Sergei can't get the kill, but he always gets a bit of nade damage. He knows the timing. It looks like they're taking short control right now. There's one under and one just holding into mid. World Edit is coming down. Alu, calm down, son. Just goes for the aggressive peek and takes him out.
I mean... He pulled. Waylander tries to pull off cheeky shots like those at the beginning of every match, trying to get some early kills. But because of that, they kind of know his pattern and what he's going to do.
Yeah, but they can't punish him for it.
Yeah.
And Kek here is trying to get a kill on a very annoying aerial in pit. And Alu is just right there as well, just causing loads of issues, and he can't get back into the main. Mm. If this smoke disappears before he can escape, he's definitely a dead man. But he manages just to escape before the smoke disappears. But Alu should be able to get a couple kills on this short push.
Oh, he moves out. He's going to take a little peek. Oh, he misses.
He heard the player go low, though.
Yeah.
And they will get A site here and plant the bomb. But this is a 5v3. And, oh, Alexi B gets a nice headshot on the Waylander on the box. Boomich tries to take a fight with the guys in CT, and this should be Norbert's
end. Norbert's already down.
But Boomich gets the kill there.
He felt like the guy was there, and he was indeed there.
Very nice kill on Ariel.
Norbert looked around at the worst time.
I think Alu just jump shot him. That's very rude. That's very rude. And easy defeat for X7 here.
Another three up.
That's 9 rounds in a row now.
That's demoralising.
Quite. And
Winstrike be able to pull through.
We called it, but the Winstrike have got another timeout here. Which means they're probably going for some strategy or just to calm the tempo down. Just try and keep the team nice and calm. But apart from that, it's not going so great for Winstrike right now.
No, it is not. Things are not looking up for them.
Okay, so what did I want to post it in? Ah, it's that one. Twitch. Okay, so we're getting back into it right now. It looks like I don't know, because the game is still frozen.
Hooray.
But as soon as we do get into it, I'll tell you exactly what it's like. Okay, so it's just, the round's just started. ENCE is going for some long control, along with the players from... Oh my god. This is just the shutdown from Alexi B and Ariel here. They just get all of the kills, but... They do get long control off the back of it when strike.
And Lexi B and Aero are already down.
Alu has been boosted onto the site. Very advanced position. X7 can catch them off here. But they're gonna... Oh no, they're going back again. X7 might be able to hear them. He will hear them. No questions asked. He knows they're there. Will he take a peek?
I was taking a bit of damage.
Nope, but
already.
He's going to give all of the info for his teammates. Look at them. Instant rotate over. Mm. This is going to be a bloodbath for... And look, Alu's getting aggressive once again. Alu will be able to... Should get one kill from this angle. It's a very close angle. It's very scary.
Oh, he goes.
And they smoke and flash that. But they're going under.
Throws
but X7, X7 can see... directly down into mid, and if he peeks at the right
moving
time,
in, oh,
he gets
yes
one,
he gets one,
and that's pretty much round done there. And obviously Alu, no, Sergei is right there.
Mm-hmm.
And Alu's taking control of that.
Just around the corner. Oh,
he knows he's on A site now, so the quick rotation from Sergei might be able to catch Boomich off.
Start smoking off the area.
As you see, Alu's pushing up short. And he's almost gets punished for that, but he doesn't quite. X7's shooting at him, Sergei's jumping at him, and Alu's takes him out. He couldn't really do much from that position, but...
I mean, Alu was on pretty low health for that one, but...
Yeah, but, like, I don't know what you can do when three players are all attacking you.
Yeah, Carton, that's going to be stressing you out as well. You're not going to be able to think as clearly...
Yeah, especially when you're trying to like fight three people at once. Mm. Like, you've got the guy jumping, you've got the guy pit, and you've got the guy
and
with the
in the back of your mind, no matter how calm of a fucker you are, having them 9 rounds up at UE3, you got to be trying pretty hard to win this round, which is pretty understandable, of course, where it's only him left and you're trying to pull this match through.
Yeah, it truly is. Like, this is 10 rounds in a row from ENCE.
Yeah.
Very, very painful if
ENCE
you are.
Hard dominating this game.
Very, very hard if you're a Winstrike here to try and keep motivated. And every time you're just getting shut down on everything you go for.
Mm-hmm.
Look how tagged they are all on long as well. Look, two players, well, one player below 30 and another player below 70, 60 health. So they've just gone for some long control, some basic long control, and they're gonna Allo's gonna get boosted onto site here. This could be very scary for Windstrike. Allo's been in a real nuisance, a real thorn in their side. But he doesn't see anything, so he goes and hides back on site. This could be a bad position.
Oh, for Allo,
and he misses the no-scope. Allo
is down. They all went up there though.
Oh, Waylander, nice flank on long. Alexi B is hiding in the smoke. He could cause a lot of issues there.
Mm-hmm.
Sergei throwing a molly and a nade on site, trying to catch Kiev off.
Alex, oh, he was... That was a good spray and pray, but he doesn't Waylander quite get can't. It.
Waylander's just... He might even get this kill.
Oh,
no!
Oh,
he ruins it. But X7's all alone now. Ooh, oh, he gets another! He could clutch this. Oh, but no. Kiev shuts him down. But thankfully, they managed to stop their 10-round streak.
Definitely. Trying to boost this back up now. Hopefully this has given them the confidence that they can try to take back control.
This is gonna really hurt them. Like, if they lose this round as well, trying to stop Ents on T side is gonna be really hard because of their momentum.
Mm.
And I don't know what strats. I haven't really seen a lot of Ents on this map.
Go for those cheeky shots again. But you know they're already going to smoke that one.
They always throw that smoke, so...
They always go for those shots and always go throw out smoke.
Oh, but... he sees one in mid there. So he has the info. And he's pushed through, Norbert has, but he's going to drop back. And I think they're going to take short control instead of going for a B-split now.
Mm.
Because of the info that Ents currently have. So everyone's just holding pretty default angles here.
Alexi
will hear that molly, but
mm.
I don't know how he'll react to it.
He's going to try and boost him.
Yep. Sergei is going for an aggressive peek into B main here. He could catch Norbert off, but or vice versa. Norbert could catch him off. But we'll have to see. Okay. So this is just going to be a little standoff here. I don't know if either of them know they're there. Norbert's going to get caught. As I called it, Norbert gets caught off there, and now Ents have the advantage in this round. It's a 4v5, and Ariel has control of long here, and with Alu's help, this would be a horrific... Oh, look at that. Two kills instantly, and world edit. Oh, this could be... instrumental from Boomich, but Boomich is dead.
Oh,
it's all done. So yeah. That is 11-4 half to Ents there.
Yeah.
Oh. You're going to have to carry on. My throat is killing.
Well, this is not looking good.
For
Windstrike.
For Windstrike here. Alu and Alexi B just carrying on the CT side there. Normally the top fragger... Sergei not really getting a huge amount of kills, but he's not needing to. As you can see, the impact's been made and the rounds have been won. So we'll have to see what Ents' T side looks like.
Yep.
God damn. I might need to get a glass of water.
Probably. Or you could try some of the tangos.
Yeah, if you could, yeah.
Yep.
Pour me a glass. Okay, so we might be having another tech pause.
Match paused.
Currently 276,000 viewers watching the stream. What do you feel about that, Fred? Not our stream, of course.
Yeah, of course not.
No one's watching ours. But this can be on. Sad. I'm going to upload this VOD to YouTube, so hopefully I'll get a decent amount of views on there.
Not going to log over the tablet.
Yeah, let's definitely not do that. Expensive piece of equipment. Well, now we can talk about whatever we want because it is the pause.
Yeah.
And it is a tech pause and all that. So what are you thinking of the match so far? Like, what have been some of your favourite moments?
Rip, win, strike. So obviously, at the moment, my number one is Alu getting the 4 kills.
Yeah, the 4K, very nice.
It's absolutely wrecking people, that one. After that, he got a lot more aggressive and still did take people's heads off like a motherfucker.
Yeah, he really did, and obviously his score reflects that, being the second highest fragger in the server, with five of the MVPs of the possible
big one 15. Being Alexi B.
And Alexi B is just being a solid anchor, getting very good kills where they're needed, and also getting a lot of them.
Yeah.
And Ariel obviously always helping out with a good 10. Mm-hmm. Sergei having a lot of impact in the mid area. And X7 just doing his job, in my opinion.
Mm-hmm.
No one on...
Hey, he has 7 kills. Like,
and obviously, World Edit and Waylander letting down the team with only 4 and 2 kills, respectively.
Mm-hmm.
You can't...
Especially World Edit trying to get those cheeky AWP shots.
Yeah.
It's just not happening.
I think it was a bit amateur the way he was trying to take the shots as well. Like it could have been much better, in my opinion. Obviously,
you understand being able to get a few shots of that, because he does it at the beginning of every round. They know he's going to do it. So as we've seen before, they're going to smoke that door and then jump over.
It's not even like I know the initial, like, everyone does the initial smoke and the initial peek into mid. Mm-hmm. It's the way he kept on peeking into mid that was amateur, in my opinion, and that's why he died a lot. As you can see, he died the second most on his team. So, yeah, that's a bit of a struggle for him to get anything going. Obviously, the game is about to start, as we can see the votes happening at the side. So, we'll just get straight into it. Obviously, this is a CT-sided map. Now, look, we can see what they're putting in chat. Have fun. So
I'm sure
we will.
I'm sure Winstrike are having a lot of fun.
A lot of fun right now. So this is.
We're going to keep an eye on the door. Gonna try and get those cheeky pistol shots.
Yeah, they're just going for the mid angles, the long angles. Oof! And he tags Alexi B in spawn there. I don't know what Alexi B was trying to do, but this is going to be free ENCE control on long. Mm. Why is there no one there from Winstrike? This could lose them this round.
Yeah, I was going to say, very condensed.
This is a very important spot for Kicker here. Or Kia. I can't... What is his name?
It's K-V-I-K.
Okay, so he gets taken down by Sergei.
Yes, absolutely right. I mean, you probably saw... They were all there.
Yeah. So, and Waylander with the 2 kills, missing a lot of shots there, and he should be taken out pretty swiftly.
Yeah.
But he is causing a lot of issues. But no, look at ENCE just taking everyone down. As I said, long position, that Kiev, or whatever his name is, was holding on a very difficult angle.
Mm.
And if he missed his shots, that's it. They lose that round. And as I say, he gets taken.
He can clearly fucking... He knows... I think I reckon he can hear. He knows he's there.
I think he's deliberately trying to bait out the movement from Boomich. And he does, and he kills him. A bit of a troll there.
Mm.
From Alex... from
yeah, Enzrin is a big old death squad and fucked them up. Especially because he only had one dude behind the car keeping his eye out. And he peaked and then got absolutely wrecked.
I think they were trying to read something ENCE had possibly done in a VOD a while ago, and they were completely off, and ENCE just destroyed them. Or maybe ENCE read them and knew they were going to go for that kind of hold.
Yeah.
X7 might... Ooh, he tags Waylander on the way past there with the...
Trying to prove that he himself can pull off some of those cheeky shots.
Alu getting 1 kill on long, and now Alexi B pushing up long with the bomb. And this Winstrike getting 2 players, World Edit,
he knows they're coming round there. He's trying to peek.
Like, obviously the info from earlier is helping him out here, but we'll have to see.
He's being brave, and
X7 takes his head off with a scout.
Completely.
And
that was a very Waylander. Ballsy move he did.
Oh, Waylander, why have you done that? You were already on
half. You saw your friend fucking die there.
Yeah, that's a very good boost from Norbert there, but obviously ENCE don't have to do anything now. They're going to slowly take long, methodically checking every angle.
Mm-hmm.
And as you can see, I don't know who necessarily is going for the flank, but one of the players is currently flanking. So,
Warrior of the Honest position missed that shot, down to 17 health.
Norbert gets tagged really low here, and Alu should catch off these 2 players. and he catches off one, and this should be the end of Norbert 2. And Alu gets the two kills there, and that's a GG on that round. Very convincing there from Ents once again. Alu now on 23 kills. Just still taking.
Well, then it went for quite a ballsy move, trying to peek around the corner. And then after Waylander fucking saw, you know, well, then it hit the sack, he went to go peek again, which was not a smart move. He should have just waited for them to... They were going to move up anyway. He would have known that.
Yeah, I don't know why he went for that ballsy peek when...
I'll say, especially since last time, forgotten that player's name again, but they were all there, and then he peeked and then got wrecked.
Yeah.
Going there on his own and trying to peek get all of them, not a good move.
So, obviously... this could be good from Waylander here, and he gets taken out, but he still takes one guy with him. Norbert is
Aerial is down.
And he manages to take out
Alexi B is down. And X7 is down.
Very Norbert nice. Is having but a... They've managed to get B site as this has all been happening. And if they can completely take this, this is one of the hardest bomb sites notoriously to take back in CSGO. So we'll have to see. But they've got Sergey and Alu on the case. Sergey, the star player, usually top fragging, and obviously Alu has been just going off this
and
game.
And Norbert had a good stand.
Alu misses those shots, and Alexi B gets World Edit getting two quick headshots there and taking this round. Well done for their first
Norbert
round.
Norbert got some good kills there and really helped them pull through.
Yeah, Norbert's been actually pretty instrumental to them winning any rounds this entire game. He's been getting some nice shots overall. So we're going to have to be watching him more to see what he can do to help them. And obviously Boomic as well is also another... He's got even more kills, so even more instrumental. I would like to see Sergey step it up a little more towards the end of this game to help Ents close it out. But obviously they have so many rounds to finish this game off. They only need three to win it. From now,
it's not looking good for Winstrike. Norbert had a good round that match, again proving his competency. But still, it might not be quite enough for Lexi B.
Waylander managing to actually get some kills here and taking out another player, taking out two players from Waylander, who had almost no impact at all on the T side. He's now making Ents' life very difficult.
Winstrike are drawing out some of their strengths here.
And we're going to see a little bit of a B hit. Sergey is going for an interesting play on short here. And Alu gets the shot. Very nice from Alu there. But this might cause...
It's corned for the time being.
Sergey might be able to catch this guy in the back, actually. Sergey's flanking round as we speak. And he might be taken out from Car, though. No, there's no one on Car. If he was to push now, he would have got at least a kill. But he's playing it safe, and he's using his advantage for now. I think he's just going to stop rotates if they happen.
Yeah, Alu's going a little peek.
Alu's going to push up short to try and get the kill on A. There's obviously a player just playing above pit for...
Well, it's hanging back there. Now he knows they're there.
There's a little gap in the smoke, but he chooses to unscope from it. And X7 has jumped into pit and gets a lovely little headshot there. Sergey, Norbert is still on the B site. And... Sergey gets the kill.
Sergey gets him.
But this round is lost because...
They had a good start as well, managing to take out Alexi B and Ariel.
Yeah, but this is just a round lost from Ents once again. I think Ents just getting a bit lost and forgetting how much time they had left, because I think they could have won that if they stuck together. But as you saw, Winstrike managed to close it out once again from a couple mistakes from Ents. As you can see, Sergey manages to save his AK from last round, and no one else has any money. So Sergey with the hero AK is going to have to make some big impact if they want to win this round.
Definitely.
But if not, this will just be another round for Winstrike.
Especially with Winstrike with the scope weapons. Winstrike might want to take advantage of this.
And they will. Waylander trying to get a kill, but Sergey does get one with the AK. He gets a lot of Boomich as well.
Oh!
But misses that kill on... If only he had anything but a Glock right there, and he might have killed him. But sadly, he has the water pistol, and obviously, against armor, it does no damage.
Yeah. Especially, yeah, Dan plays a lot of Alu's strengths, which is a shame, because he probably could have got that shot, definitely.
Yeah. He does manage to survive there, but Ariel gets quickly taken out from... Ooh, Alu, he gets down the shot behind him.
6-7, he sees Waylander. Ooh, he might just take him out, and it's too late.
Yeah, it's too late for them there. It's just another swift round from Winstrike. They should be winning that all day long, in my opinion. I don't know if they're going to call a pause here. No, they're going to go for the bye. I think it's the right decision. Gives them a chance to win the round, of course.
Yeah.
But we'll have to see. Alexi B not bought yet. And he bought a Gleal, and they tried to get a shot for the smoke.
GB shots.
But it doesn't matter. They've already crossed. And Wayland is holding the same angle as last time. Just seeing if he can see anyone over the smoke. He's had a lot of impact in that position, so... Interesting boost for Boomich here. We'll see what he can do with it. Doesn't look like they have a lot of aggression towards this area, though. And he drops off and will probably drop back to the pit area. Ooh, nice shot from World Edit there to get Alexi B out of the situation. Takes his head right off his shoulders. So, World Edit will just drop back to a more superior position and just hold it. And, X7 just spraying through the smoke there. Not expecting anything from it. Maybe get tag a player up a little bit. But it looks like they're going to go for a bit of mid control here. This could cause a lot of issues for Winstrike if the players manage to get the impact and the kills they should. Ariel's got a very interesting position in the smoke right now.
Oh, wait, he just managed to get Waylander.
And this means they might have B control.
Oh,
but no,
Ariel's down already. So is Norbert.
Gets two.
Jesus, Norbert.
Norbert, calm down. So Norbert manages to basically win that round for Winstrike there. By
definitely, because things weren't looking good for them.
No.
Ariel fucking slapped Waylander. Was Ariel so okay? Can't actually remember. That's terrible of me.
It was Ariel.
Good. Yeah. I was right. Yeah. Ariel slaps big old Waylander, but then Norbert, and then just went down for Norbert, and he saw him. Took a bit off, and then Norbert managed to pull through.
So, let's see. Yeah. The Winstrike guy is just kind of just evening the kills out across the board there. Like, no one's really taking the game away. They're just kind of doing it by committee.
Yeah. And we'll get back on there real quick.
We are... And obviously...
I'll say, they're starting to pull up a little bit. As we know, because World Dinner and Waylander were on like 2-1.
Yeah.
In the first major round when they were terrorists.
Yeah, and Alu hasn't got he's only got one kill since I last checked to score.
Yeah.
And ElectTB hasn't got any.
So they're picking things up here.
So Winstrike are picking things up. ENCE are struggling, but this will just be a simple pistol round for ENCE. So if they win this will be heartbreaking for Winstrike. But they shouldn't.
Winstrike, all with their scoped weapons.
Of course. And
look in that area. They're all going through.
Oh, Norbert could get...
And he's down!
God. Oh my god, two quick kills there from...
Yeah, well, they're just trying to go back in. They're trying to save the situation.
But this is going to be incredibly difficult for Winstrike to get this here. The two quick kills straight away. Very scary.
Distance in the area.
For Winstrike. But this is World Edit just trying to peek around the corner to see if he can catch anyone out. But they are not giving him anything at all.
No, they are not. X7 is right in the corner. He's surrounded, but he's sticking strong. And he's down already.
X7 manages to be taken out. Okay, but they don't know of Alexi B's position. And he gets a headshot there. But they can... Oh my god, Alu! And he gets one kill. And
Alexi B.
This is ENCE's round. ENCE manages to take that round on the pistol buy.
It was a tough one, though.
It was a tough...
Fucking Winstrike went in there and they had it. They were almost there.
Yeah. Alexi B's positioning was actually very clever there. To hide in tunnel and let Boomich cross and then come behind him. It, just a very intelligent play after plant positions from ENCE there. and Winstrike not being able to capitalize on the fact that they had better weapons than the ENCE side.
For a little cheeky shot. So, ENCE, not only using the pistols now, finally getting into the weapons, all of them with an AK, except Alu.
Ooh, very nice shot there from World Edit, once again on aerial. Obviously, Waylander, the only one with not a full weapon. And aerial. Oof. And World Edit's been a real nuisance on this position. But obviously, Alu is gonna is probably bigger nuisance than anyone else in the server right now with 26 kills. We'll have to see.
He's waiting for it. Nothing's
happening. Just waiting for any aggression at all. Sergei, like, knowing this guy, like, knowing where Boomich exactly will be.
Gets a few shots.
He shoots through the door a little bit because I think he knows Boomich's position, but he's just going to back off, I believe Sergei is. He shouldn't go for this, I don't think.
I don't think so, he says. None of them seem, they're a bit of a stalemate at the moment. Neither of them really want to move.
Alu has come to long now. This position from Boomich is going to ruin this if they can't predict it. But I think Sergei knows, and he does.
Takes out Boomich.
That is a very scary fight for both of them. Like, that's a very important one. And that's pulled the player to rotate to A. So if they do go B here, they could actually take this round. Especially if they were to go through mid, but they're going to go A.
And he goes for the smoke. No sight flash.
And he should be taken out from Waylander and the World Edit.
Oh!
Waylander gets taken out.
Alu just manages to catch that fucker.
And, oh, and yeah, Norbert comes round. The good flank, and he shoots him right in the head.
Nice one.
Well, that was a scary round for a second there. But the time wasn't on their side, and ENCE can't take that one home. But they do only need two more rounds, and one more round to make sure that they cannot lose before going to overtime. So this is just a straight pistol round, not even any upgraded pistols, just the water pistols all round, or Glocks as people like to call them.
Nice little bit of B-hopping there. However, Waylander's on the other side of the door and just manages to catch him. Good play from Waylander.
And, oh, that's...
Lucky
he has the guy standing in the
Kavik had his back then.
And they managed...
only pulls it off on fire, motherfucker. Wow.
I know, right? I think...
that was a quick one, though.
Yeah, it was. I think...
I had some good shots there. Kavik, well, that's what I'm going to call him.
Kavik. Yeah, Kavik. Yeah, that works.
Kavik.
We can call him Kavik. So, this should be another buy round for ENCE here. They really need to capitalize on
one
of them.
Now, only four rounds away. They were leagues ahead of them at the moment, but now Winstrike is trying to pick things back up.
He legs Norbert on the cross there. Oh my god, X7 getting two kills there! Insane! Oh my god,
he was very brave, but he managed to just catch
Sergei manages to catch. Oh my god, this is ENCE's round. They can't lose this now. Waylander will have to pull a fucking god tier move off here for any of this to work. And they don't know of his position yet, but they're gonna jump, they're gonna run boost across. If he can catch this, but this is a very easy shot.
Ooh.
Waylander whiffing that shot there. He should always be getting that one, but he was probably...
If he did, then... Ooh.
He was probably just surprised to see two players on top of each other's heads as he comes around the corner. But, another round for ENCE. They just need one more, and obviously a timeout called from probably Winstrike, I believe, and that's every timeout called that they can call in this entire game from Winstrike.
Mm-hmm.
I do agree, this is a very difficult just game for Winstrike at the moment. They're struggling a lot here, and I don't know how they can bring this back. I think this is ENCE just needs to get one of the next five rounds, and they've won. So they might even be able to close it out on this one. What do you think?
They're definitely picking back up. ENCE were leagues ahead of them, but now Winstrike is trying to pick up. However, I don't think it's quite enough yet. No. Five rounds is still quite a lot.
Yeah. So one of those.
Winstrike could do it, but the chances aren't looking the greatest. ENCE might have this.
I believe ENCE do have this, but obviously this is a best of three, so we'll go into the next map after this. I don't know whose map choice this was. Alexi B just standing on top, getting a few shots down on Boomich there, but Boomich not really being affected by it. Only taking like 10 points of health. But yeah, this is obviously a best of three. And I don't know exactly whose map this is, whose map pick this is. But if we do this quickly, we'll be able to find out. If you type in HLTV. So we've just got a basic default here from ENCE. Nothing too flashy. X7 just spraying a little bit through the smoke. So we're just going to check. Okay, so this map pick so far. I don't know who picked the map.
Winstrike remove Inferno, ENCE remove Cache, Winstrike Dust 2, ENCE pick Mirage, ENCE pick Newt, remove Newt.
Okay, so this is Winstrike's map they chose. So if they lose this and then ENCE get to go to the map they chose on Mirage, this could be it for Winstrike.
I mean, they clearly had a plan involved because they were three rounds up when they first started and they're the ones who picked that map.
Boomich takes down Sergei. X7 takes down Waylander. A nice molly thrown onto site there. This is a very important position from World Edit. If he doesn't get the kill... Oh, he gets the kill on Alu there through the smoke. Oh, but he doesn't see Alexi B, and Alexi B takes him down. Alexi B
nice
planting the bomb.
Wrap
C4. Oh, Kev, or Kiev, or whatever his name is.
Kavik.
Kavik just manages to just jump shot him there.
Yeah. Putting down a nice little wrapped up C4 present, but Kavik ain't having any of that shit. No C4
this is
presence
all down
to him,
X7, and X7 just not hitting any of his shots. And
he almost had him, but yeah.
Norbert just punishes him there from missing too many. So that's another round for Winstrike, and I think that should push ENCE onto a half buy here, so they'll just have pistols once again. But we've seen what they can do with pistols,
yeah,
and that's a scary prospect for any
team.
They
are going for pistol rounds.
So,
Most of them going for weapons. All of them going for axes, except for Boomich, who's going for an AK.
Well, he obviously picked it off the floor last round.
Definitely.
So, X7, the only one. Well, actually, they've all basically bought up to an extra pistol, apart from Ariel, who doesn't have
Wayland the way to get the door. Go and smoke.
Throwing a molly there. Taking a lot of damage. Taking a lot of fucking health from the ENCE boys. But obviously, he can't see anything because of the Xbox smoke they have thrown. I think this is just a very fast hit from ENCE here. It's bad timing for World Edit to unscope.
Oh no, he's shot.
He gets taken down again from ENCE. Doing a lot of damage with these pistols every time they manage to pull them out. And now ENCE boys both have weapons, including an AWP. And X7 gets a shot through the wall there, and that's it. ENCE managed to do it again on a pistol round. Like I said, a very scary prospect, and X7 going big right there at the end of the game. Everyone picking it up from ENCE, and they managed just to finish it on a pistol round. Very nice play from ENCE there.
So from both sides, as we can see, you got Boomich at number one, or most kills on his team with 21, and Alu with 27.
Alu crushing at that game, along with Alexi B and X7 picking it up on T side to take
it. It seemed like World only got a bit flustered there, because he managed to scope in, almost get a shot, and then obviously trying to move around, they all flash and just took him out at once.
Yeah, and obviously they didn't recover from that, and the game was all over.
Nope. Pistols only.
So I think we're going to have to leave this server quickly and wait for the next one to come up. So obviously, I don't know how much of a time gap they get in between each game. Oops, that's not what I wanted. Twitch. Oh man. Okay, we're gonna have to wait for the advert here. Just see if the server comes up. I know they get a little break now. So.
Yeah.
Oh man, that was actually a pretty crazy game.
That was a pretty crazy game. Still, my favorite hyper was fucking Alu with that 4K.
Yeah, that was very nice. Like, him with the AWP is just sick, dude.
Even in like other times where he didn't do as much, you saw what was like just taking dudes' heads off.
Yeah, no, like he wasn't messing about at all. No. Like he was just.
Hey, GG or Winstrike Spark, because they were far behind, but they managed to start bringing themselves back up. Norbit did well. World did it, and Waylander proved that they can do this shit.
True.
And they clearly have skill, but they just weren't with it today.
No.
Especially on that last round with Waylander getting completely... Oh, no, not Waylander. World did it, getting completely flustered that last bit when they all came around with their pistols.
True. I don't really know what they could have done there. Actually, the advantage that...
It was a pretty tricky game. Well, except for their better weaponry being their advantage.
Yeah, no, like I mean, like, the advantage from Ents to have the amount of rounds they did coming into that half really, I think, just screwed over any chances of Winstrike winning that.
Yeah. Winstrike picked the map. They had a good start, so clearly they had a plan for it. It was working well.
Yeah.
But then Ents had a big fuck off comeback. 10 rounds in a row,
yeah. Genuinely just 10 rounds straight without losing one.
Completely dominating the match. Winstrike again picked it back up, but it wasn't quite enough.
Yeah, and it wasn't at all for Winstrike.
Mm-hmm. Especially since a lot of the match they did win, they did come with heavy casualties.
Yeah.
Ents were able to go through with maybe one loss, two.
Yeah, like
even in some of the heavier games, they still fucking pulled through.
Yeah, they managed to get a lot of just Ents always closed out the rounds they should have won, and Winstrike, as we saw, they lost two rounds against pistol buys at the end, which just shouldn't be happening. I know it does happen, and it did twice.
Yeah,
but if you have full weapons, you should not be losing to pistols.
No.
And I think that's what their major downfall was, like, just losing to those pistol rounds, which is demoralizing enough when it happens once.
Oh, yeah.
But, and then it happens twice to end the game against you. That's going to suck.
Well, they should have seen from the last match how Ents always stick together in the big group, which they should have used that to their advantage.
Yeah.
And if they had to go a pistol round, they're probably going to be together. But still, Ents managed to pull it off in their big little death squad of fucking wrecking dudes left, right, center.
It was,
Pardon me.
Like, it's not an uncommon strategy for pistol rounds to do that, but it was very successful.
Oh, yeah.
Ents using it against the Winstrike team. I don't know what Winstrike could have done there against Ents. Ents was just the best team, and they managed to, just take out the
Waylander. I feel like Waylander and World did it were a bit not underplay, that's not the right word, but they definitely could, as we've seen in some of their matches, they can do well.
Yeah,
they can, but I don't know what was it, they just weren't, it's almost like they weren't there. I see, because they were on the lowest at some point. The lowest
they were of... like after the first half they were some of the lowest players, and that must have really, like, Waylander managed to bring it back a little bit in that game, but he just couldn't quite do it. Okay, so here's the player scores by the end of that game. Yeah, World Edit and Waylander on the bottom of the scoreboard with 10 and 14 kills respectively.
They managed to bring themselves back up a little bit, but it just wasn't enough.
Look at their deaths, though. Look at Waylander, 25 deaths.
Yeah.
That it just isn't good enough, in my opinion.
No.
And obviously, like, he got 15 more deaths than he got kills. So, very, very weak from the side of Winstrike there.
Mm.
Obviously, Boomich still going positive.
I'll say, he's trying to hold things together as best he can.
Like, I feel like he kind of goes under the radar as kind of an unsung hero, in my opinion, because we didn't really see much from him.
It was very... I don't think he got any big bursts. Something we've seen from Norbit, he got an... definitely Alu, but Norbit got some like nice bursts of kills, whereas his was just more like a few at a time.
Yeah.
A bit spread out. But I think he maybe... bursts are kind of random, and you can't really think to go for a burst, but I think he definitely could have been a bit more aggressive.
I agree with that statement. I also think, like I said, he kind of goes a bit under the radar because his kills aren't as flashy, like we just said. but he's obviously getting them, and if he could convert
them...
If he could convert them more into, like, I don't know what the way to put it. Like, just like, get them through into more impactful. That's definitely what I mean.
Well, because that's the thing, though. Because being that he is at the moment, being their heavy hitter.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's specifically his job on the team, but they better make it his job soon because he's doing well, but clearly things just aren't working out. Because Waylander and Worldedit are the ones going for those tricky, you know, sniper shots, but they're just not getting them.
That is very true. So we're just gonna have to wait for this game to start here, and as you can see at the top, 16-11 to ENCE in the first game. Mm. It was very well played from the ENCE side. Like I can't lie, they deserve to win that first game because they just completely just ruined any chances that Winstrike had. In my opinion, they just couldn't do it. So.
This is their second match.
Yep, this is the second match. At the moment, I think they're just on their quick break. Obviously, the server's up, but we're gonna have to wait for a little bit. That's why I had the stream up actually to see how long it would take to start this. I'm actually just gonna
ready for Twitches over.
Just do something quickly.
No punch in cupboard, please.
I need to change my trousers and my legs again.
Zach and the little dirty cupboard puncher.
Okay, we got 5 minutes until the match starts here. So, I guess we just take a break. If you can fill in for a sec, let my voice recover. Because that was a lot of effort to constantly be talking.
You can always use to get the pizza now.
Leave like in the middle of the game.
Oh, we'll just piss all the good stuff.
I can get some crisps if you want.
Oh, yes, yeah, that'd be cool.
Snacks.
Oh, sick.
Oh. Getting nice and comfortable here. Gonna be taking a quick break. Oh, stream's frozen.
Yes, Graham.
There's some crisps.
Sick. Here we go. Warm up round. So, new match, new map. I know, well, obviously they should, but being pro CS players, I know this map well. I know what kind of plans Will and Windstrike is going to do to try and take this back. So obviously they're really going to try, being that they they might actually bring it back up at the end. But that was a big old loss last map. So clearly they're going to be wanting to win this one to, you know, get back up there.
As we can see, the guy who's controlling the view cams right now is just having a bit of fun with it. Enjoying his job whilst he has to wait for the game to start.
Yep, as anyone would.
Mm-hmm. Let's see him fly around.
Let's go into the 3D model, see if we can get inside their heads. See what they're thinking. Won't be anything there because it's a fucking 3D model, but that's not the point.
You might be just setting up some shots for when the game starts. Those crisps are actually pretty good, aren't they?
Oh yeah, pretty good. Thank you. Oh shit.
Orange focus.
Swapping their little warp. Telling me you can't see it. That's a big old shame. The cameraman can just, you know, let us view.
Probably talking to his boss or his other guys on the team right now.
Sick.
I mean, you're going like, that last game was pretty cool. Alu's epic.
The little one round, when Winstrike just kind of getting wrecked.
Yep.
No one's died. ENCE died, yep.
It's just the warm up, that's why. Maybe we should just shoot them.
I know.
AFK and
smoke. Yeah. Still. Any good CS game, just get to the smallest fastballs and just murder them over and over again. I've experienced that. Not so fun to get out of.
No. Luckily, it's only the warm up, and you can't do that in the actual game.
Oh, thank God.
Well, the game should start very shortly here, as I believe. They're currently just... Oh, they're having some tech issues. That's fucking...
Brave.
At least this time they haven't started the map. And then had to pause. World Edit's computer is currently just being under maintenance. So they can check that it's working correctly. ENCE guys just look very focused. Just laughing to each other, having a chat as this is the pre-match is happening. Probably just getting into the right mindset when the game actually does start. Infinite Pringles.
Say that is not true. We've seen the infinite drink.
Yikes.
Let me show you the infinite drink back. Real quick. Just real quick, just so you know you have infinite. Oh, here we go, infinite. Yeah, here we go. This man's drink is actually infinite. Let's just watch.
Oh. Oh, I see. See you right now.
Very.
The woman takes it off him. Okay, it looks like we'll be kicking it off very shortly here.
Now Zach's mentally disturbed, he's ready for the match.
Yep. So let's get back into casting mindset. Okay, the match is about to start between Winstrike and ENCE, round two. This is ENCE's map pick, so ENCE should win this, so it should just be a swift 2-0, but you never know. They're saying good half and chat to each other. So, we just have to see how this one goes. So, Windstrike is going for a B stack here, and they've read them perfectly. As you can see, ENCE is going B. And this could be very bad for ENCE.
Oh! Morbot there, all on his own. Xtem's going to take him out, and he's down.
But this is a 2v4 for Ence right now. But Ence gets another kill.
Rylander already down.
Alexi B is going to have to do this all on his own. And he does get another one. This could be an epic pistol round from Alexi B. If he knows the guy's on short, he could be taken out from that. If he doesn't check short, he's going to be taken down very shortly.
Holy shit, this is a tough one, but Alexi might be able to do it. He wants
and
to put his team
he just
time.
Wants to go get the bomb. And he should...
Oh, it's a bit of a rip. Oh,
he knows the short guy's there now. And he gets taken out. So that's a swift pistol round there from Winstrike. They managed to read the play, and they managed to get a kill.
GG though on Alexi B Mash surviving that long.
So Winstrike managed to get the first round there, so they should be able to get another two after this, but we'll see. It looks like they're just going to be going mid the T's here. The nade doesn't do as much damage as World Edit would have liked. But I don't know if Ence is waiting for a push. Nope, they're all coming up together now. And they should just all be taken out pretty swiftly, but they are doing some nice damage. If only they can finish a player off.
He's going around the back.
Around the back.
GG on Norbert.
Two nice shots from Norbert.
And no losses.
I'm just trying to keep it nice and clean in the first anti-eco.
Definitely trying to make sure they're not losing this round. Trying to keep control of the whole match.
Yeah. This is Ence's first buy round. So this is where we actually get to see where the round properly starts. Apart from the utility, it'll be a little bit low on Ence here.
Mm-hmm. All going AK?
All going AK. They couldn't afford the AWP. Like I said, their money was a little bit tight going into this round.
Mm-hmm.
And Boomich is going for the push under. He could... Two are pushing under here.
They
don't get anything, and they just drop. They just drop back to mid. They're going to drop back to the A site here. And
Seven's
playing
in waiting.
And this is going to be... No, they're rotating off B by the looks of it.
Okay, going up there.
Oh.
Norbit's just managed to get the headshot on X7.
Nice shot from
well
Norbert
done, Norbit.
There.
Well done.
That was two nice headshots from Norbert to get that kill so swiftly. Alexi B is still playing in a pretty similar position to his teammate here. And
me and slow. Norbert's is there. He's keeping a lookout. Is he in a peek? Nope.
Oh, he gets rid of the AK to stop the enemy from getting a clever decision there.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, the AK is more powerful than MP9, as you could imagine.
Good decisions.
And it looks like Ents are going to go for a mid-split to B here. Yeah, I would be correct. Waylander could get a load of info there. He sees two. And Norbert has changed to the other side, and he's got a teammate who might push short. His teammate will push short. He really needs to get a kill here, and he turns around at the wrong second. It's taken out pretty swiftly. Norbert also gets taken out. Waylander pushing in. Ooh, doing a lot of damage. Almost catching the guy off with the bomb. Not managing to get any kills, though, but gets taken out through the smoke by Ariel there. That was a very close one from Ents, and this will be a save from the Winstrike side.
XB quickly planting the bomb.
And this is Ents's first round. Boomich might go for this because he doesn't have a very good weapon. Might just try and go for some exits. And as you can see, Ents side is all pretty low on health.
Mm.
So he could actually get some pretty easy kills. But as you can see, Alu's in the apartment.
He's
position.
Not sure. Yeah, Alu's moving up. And Alu's on full health.
And Boomich catches them all crossing. He might go for a ninja defuse here. Oh no, he just goes to pick up a weapon. Oh, very clever decision from him. And now he has another free upgrade. But he did lose almost all his teammates.
He did lose the rounds, but it was a smart save on his hand. He could have gone for that ninja defuse, like you said, but I don't think he was going to get that.
It wasn't worth it.
No. Definitely, this is the best, a better, more conservative way.
Talking about Boomit, she hasn't got any kills, any deaths, or any assists.
Well, lucky being that he was top of his team. Whirlwind edit, though. Bringing himself forward. GG, my dude.
And Alexi B again. Three kills, friends. He's been doing really well this series.
Mm. Smoking the place out.
World edit gets smoked off there, so he can't hold top mid anymore. As you can see, top mid control completely given up to Ents there after they throw that smoke. And as you can see, World Edit trying to get some control, but they're just going to drop out a connector. But Kev there still. I keep on forgetting his name. Kavik.
It's called Kavik. We probably butchered it a little bit, but we're going with Kavik.
Kavik moving out of the connector position. A nade on
the ground. Tad bit of damage and he's down.
Sergey tries to go for a kill there, but he gets taken out. He was being a little too greedy.
Lexi B.
Lexi B on short. Ooh. Waylander.
He's backing off though.
And World Edit. And Boomich gets a kill each. On them.
X7 is down.
X7 gets taken out.
No, and he's also down. Good, clean win from Winstrike.
Very nice round from them. Nothing too special, but getting the job done is all that matters
exactly.
At the end of the day. So, they did perfectly here.
Mm-hmm.
But this is the scariest round for a win strike, as we've seen almost every time. This is not a full bought up Ents. They've got pistols. And whenever you see pistols in Ents' hands, I would be scared if I was Winstrike, because we knew what happened last time, especially on T-side.
Yeah, definitely. Especially from what we saw last time. Three rounds up, then Ents starts to dominate. I wonder if it'll be similar this time, where Winstrike will get ahead and then Ents are going to start dominating.
Yeah, they'll figure something out. Ents got a lot of control here. Windstrike is going to have to go for a combined burst.
Is it flooded? X7 is down.
Oh, but Alexi B gets a kill there.
Go for a flash.
Alu's behind. And
Alexi B
gets one.
Takes more bits.
And Alu gets
that
one connector.
Takes
that
way, oh, shit.
But World Edit gets one kill there. Alu might catch him off.
Is there? No, he's getting hit. No, and he's down.
Sergey gets...
Kavik?
Sergey gets the knife and the smoke and finishes that round off, but Ents getting another win, and Alu manages to sneaky take the AWP and run away. Oh, man.
Oh, there he is, holding his proud possession.
I know, right? I would be a proud man after getting that AWP, too. That's gonna hurt, like
definitely.
I said.
Especially from what we've seen last time with AWP man Alu.
That's gonna hurt if you're Winstrike, though. Losing to another half-buy from Ents, and it seems to always be the half-buys that are catching out this Winstrike.
Well, like we said,
team.
Ents particularly proven their skill with pistol rounds.
Truly
pistols in general. Okay, he's getting smoked.
World Edit or get smoked off again.
He's down.
This is gonna be
Alexi
a
B's
run
getting boosted
boost from Alexi B, but not having to do that because
they give it trying to get his head of the clouds. He's not gonna quite do it though. No, he's covered up.
He's just trying to spot anything and doesn't spot anything at all. Norbert going for a little bit of a peek on the chair position there.
A nice quiet start. Oh, here we go. Alexi B.
But Alexi B backs,
no, backs off. A wise decision.
And Ariel drops the bomb to Alexi B. And Winstrike smoke off there so they can get a player into ladder room.
Get a Molotov in there though, it burns him a little bit, it's going to force him outside.
Burned by that. Molly takes over half his health.
Forces him outside though. Get smoked, the smoke side of clear. Okay.
Kavik manages to get a kill here, Ariel trades it, but
Alu
missing a shot with the AWP.
Mm.
Sergey on the A site and Alu gets taken out by Kavik and Boomich.
Winstrike again.
Winstrike just playing this very...
Playing it very conservatively. Not trying to do anything too fancy.
No.
Not trying to rush in there and take all the glory, but very you know, together. They're playing as a team as really well. They're together.
Yeah, just playing as a team.
Keeping it calm, blocking off the area, staying in a decent formation.
And as you can see, ENCE are going for a... They'll probably go for a half buy here because their money isn't good enough.
Yeah.
They're going to have to twice in a row go for it. But they called a timeout so they can talk about it and go decide what they want to do next and maybe calm the players down. Maybe get some input from their coach. Yeah. But we're about to see them kick into this. We'll see if they buy or not.
Well, we'll see how it goes down. Because like we saw last time, remember Winstrike was ahead at the beginning in ENCE and Smash there. I don't know if the situation will be like that this time, where ENCE is going to start fucking destroying them. But then again, Wayland is doing pretty well. He might be able to just hold this thing down.
It's another half buy from ENCE. This is scary if you're Winstrike once again. This... I don't know what it is with these kind of rounds. They just can't seem to deal with ENCE on them. I think it's maybe ENCE just needs a quick burst out every time because it seems to catch this Winstrike team off.
Yeah.
But we'll see. This is, like I said, going to be a quick push onto the A site. They're already out, but Boomich manages to get a good quick kill there.
This is... Oh! But, got a cheeky little headshot. GG, my dude.
Kvic manages to get the headshot from the connector position. This hasn't been so successful. Boomich lucky to survive there, but... They managed to survive that pistol round from ENCE, so ENCE are going to have to full save this one. So this should be another easy round for the Winstrike side.
I'll say, at the moment, what we can see, ENCE aren't doing too well on kills. Warden is in the lead, he's pulling himself up, that boy.
And obviously Kvic also having a lot of impact from that connector position.
Nice, nice.
So that's good to see. Like we
pure
said,
pistols from ENCE though, and we know how those rounds go from previous matches. However, let's see if they've learned anything from this. Oh no, he just managed to get two of them.
The guy Boomich.
Oh geez, oh, that boy. God. Calm Four down, mate. Let's chill.
If that wasn't a full save from ENCE, that would be much better than it was, but it's still a 4k either way, so nice 4k from Boomich there.
Yeah, Boomich went in there hard. He had that corner down.
Let's hope he can do it on this gun round now.
Especially since last time we saw those kind of plays from ENCE where they had the gunplay, normally when they get flustered, normally get taken the fuck out. But Boom kept his cool and he was taking them out. He messed them up on the few of the early shots and only had one of the players down to death. You managed to pull through in the end. GG.
Normally, like Winstrike, they've managed to win when they've had all Glocks, but if they've had a half buy where they've had P2
smoked out, he's going for some random shots.
He didn't manage to hit anything there, but Kvic again.
Oh, and he's down.
Killed through the smoke, but Waylander causing a lot of issues here, but getting killed. Waylander's
quickly taken out.
So.
3-on-3.
Ariel's the one last in mid. He's just going to be a nuisance, I believe. And they're going to collectively go to A together, Alu and Sergei. Sergei's position is going to be very important here. Boomich might be able to catch Alu off, but Alu is expecting it. He's already scoped in. And he might... Boomich manages just to miss Alu here. But if Alu isn't careful, but he sees him. Alu sees Boomich. So
he's moving in slowly.
Alu tries to flash Boomich here.
Oh, okay. Boomich has no sight. Oh, is he up? No, he's ran off.
It's
a nice distraction though. Boomich isn't afraid though, he's going in there.
Alu's completely gone out of his view now. But Alu just can't take a break. If he's not careful, Boomich could take him out, and Norbert could take him out here.
Alu's trapped in the corner, though. Oh, he gets flashed. Is he going to go out? Yes, he is. Oh, wait, no, Boomich isn't there anymore.
But Sergei's got control of the A site, and he gets the kill on Boomich here, so this should be just easy for Alu to get in.
And well, then it goes around the... Oh, no, he doesn't go down there. If he went down there, he might have been able to catch Sergei.
World Edit is...
Alu's going to plant. No, it's too late.
Oh, the connector position from... A little hole in the smoke, I believe, for Norbert there, and Sergei the only one surviving with an AK. And that was a very good round from Winstrike there.
Definitely. They're picking things back up, though. It's surprising.
I think it's I think I don't know really how to put it, but ENCE is kind of playing this a bit too scrappy.
Yeah,
get taken out really easily. I think they need to try and
Winstrike has definitely got a lot tighter on their play style.
Yeah,
they're playing a bit more conservatively, which is definitely working. It's their plans. They're taking this one. However, it's not down and out for ENCE. So got plenty of time to retake this.
Sure have. I think best thing that ENCE can do right now is actually Boomage almost getting taken out there. And World Edit getting a kill with the PSP through the smoke.
I could definitely see what you mean by scrappy, because some of those kills, I feel like in the last match, ENCE got those kills and they got those headshots, but they're not really, they're going in there, they're getting the shots, but they're not really hitting straight away.
Yeah.
And Winstrike are just managing to pull off either surviving or winning like that.
Yeah, like I said,
not even not even any casualties for them. Like Kavik went down, and so did Boomage a little bit, but they still managed to pull through.
True that.
I understand what you mean by the scrappy gameplay now.
Yeah, do you see what I mean? Like, they're not quite.
They definitely
off.
Need to kind of form to. Need to collect themselves, if anything.
Yeah, they need to. I think they might just go for a straight A execute here, from what I can see. Or no, they're just going for a default. Just the default again. They're going for that mid control, and it hasn't really worked for them.
No, it hasn't been so far. It's been useful in blinding Winstrike, but it's not really working though, because Winstrike can pull through in the end. They've managed to catch them out multiple times.
Yeah.
I'd say maybe some tactic plans are. Yeah. Maybe some plans are in need of changing, because this isn't working.
Yeah, that's what I was saying.
He's going. He's revealed his spot though. They know where he is. They go for a Molly.
Alexi B is dead. And I think what.
Norbert is going around the back. Ariel's trapped in there. Okay. He's taken out quickly.
Aloe needs Aloe's to get trying something to get done here. Trying to shoot Boomich through the box. This is going to be a hard take for ENCE here.
Definitely. Well, then it's down.
But, yeah, quick shot from Sergei here. But, like I said, Norbert's positioning is just so overpowered at this point. If his timing is correct, he could catch off.
Oh! Aloe. Takes out Aloe!
X7 manages to trade Aloe out. And X7 almost gets Kvick. But Sergei is kind of just stuck in this position now.
He's cornered right now and he's down.
And he gets taken down from two
Again,
angles.
Winstrike's positioning was too good. They had both sides. He was going to get hit from one of the other. So he didn't have much choice. I reckon if he stayed in cover a bit longer and tried to take out the two on the side. However, I think they only came out. I think they were peeking, came out of cover just as he went for the other one.
Yeah,
it was that left him wide open. And they just got in there.
Pretty unlucky for ENCE there. ENCE currently in their timeout once again to try and reorganize or maybe restrategize.
They definitely need to do that at the moment because Winstrike are doing well.
Winstrike are really taking advantage of the weaknesses of. ENCE here. They've obviously done a lot of research on the Mirage of ENCE. It's interesting to see that ENCE chose this map.
Yeah. And they're definitely doing a lot less, again, like cheekier shots that they always tried to do in the last round. They're keeping it together. They're taking their shots and they're hitting, more importantly.
True. I think, yeah, there was something that was going wrong for the Winstrike side last time. They just couldn't quite get their shots to be hitting like they should have been. And ENCE is having the same issue this game at the moment.
Yeah.
They're going to have a monster CT side to make this comeback, but they're just going to have to see if they can get these last rounds on the T side.
So, Boom is now back in the lead with 13 kills. Next up is Kvick with 12. Wardener with 10. He was on 9 last time, so he hasn't gone up too much.
Yeah, I'm
only 1, obviously. However, Norbert is on 6, and the other one is on 7. Compared to
ENCE's kill count, it's not looking too good.
No, ENCE is struggling here. I think they're just, they're just going for a basic B rush. They did go for a half buy here.
Being a lot quicker, they're moving in smoother. However, World Edit's already on there. Is he gonna?
He didn't take the shot. Oh, he does.
Alexi B is down.
He
doesn't quite get that one. However, Norbert is there. Takes him out.
This is just a death trap for the ENCE side.
No, they just managed to catch him out. However, that was too risky, especially at the loss of their play. And only Aloe left.
And Aloe gets taken out through the smoke.
That was horrible to see. Alu was there for too long. He'd been there too long, and they managed to catch
him. He was trying to get the M4. That's
he was trying to get the M4, but still.
Yeah. And
if he was a bit smoother, he could have done better, but then again.
Like I said, he was trying to get the M4 to save a bit of extra money, but didn't matter in the end anyway. He gets taken out through the smoke.
Okay, Alu back on, or the rest of them on AKs?
I don't know.
Winstrike going back to their scoped weapons, which they're actually pulling through with now. They're got three orgs going... and one orb. Sorry, two orbs.
Okay, so they're going for an under.
Lexi
B could catch them off.
Ooh.
But Kavik manages to get the headshot there, and now this is just a fawn in end.
I don't think I've seen too much of Norbert with an orb, though.
No, neither have I.
He's got aerial. Kavik's holding strong. I see, because normally Waylander I see him with Norbert, but he's clearly switched out for an org.
Alu did see him and takes
Kavik. Nice, that was a bit of a risky move that Kavik took.
Boomich has managed to sneak past into the apartment's position. This is very interesting. This could catch Alu off. This will catch Alu off. What am I saying?
He didn't go down there.
Alu went round the corner too fast.
Ooh, Boomich, he's being risky.
Oh, X7. X7 getting two there. Very nice.
That patience.
I know, right?
He could have taken the kill right then and there, but he wasn't desperate. He took his time and he waited. And he managed to just sneak in those two kills. GG.
They call that trigger discipline, and he has a lot of it.
He's clearly doing very well. He was patient with that. Which I definitely think that kind of playstyle is definitely something that I think Ence could use a bit more, because he waited, didn't rush in there, and then managed to get those two sneak kills. And we know that people like Alu... and you know, LXEB.
Yeah.
We know that both of them can get some sick shots.
Yeah.
If they had a bit more patience like that, I think they could definitely. Picking this up.
I don't know why they keep on going for the same default. It's obviously not working.
They need a bigger chair. I think they've done some small changes in their general playstyle, but it's not big enough though. They're not actually. Again, look, they're going for the good old mid. They're trying to take control of mid.
Oh my god, Alexi B and Ariel getting two kills.
That was quite aggressive, but a loss of two of their players. There's one down, only two left.
Oh, Kavik getting a swift 3k, not even letting them execute on the site.
He's jumped up to 17. What a lad. I was gonna say, what a boy, but it just doesn't matter. No, that was quite an aggressive round. I think it works well, but I felt like it was a bit. Like I said, scrappy. I think that aggressiveness was a bit too scrappy. Which is why when they got, like... Ence got some good kills there, but they got taken out pretty quickly.
Yeah, I agree with that. Like, I know they... I agree they need to put on the aggression. And I don't mind if they play scrappy, but I think they all need to go together.
That aggression was good, but it wasn't as controlled. They went in there quick, and they caught Winstrike off guard a bit. But Winstrike quickly recovered, though. Especially from the kills where they'd get one and then Winstrike would quickly finish off that Ence player.
Yeah. So, we can see Norbert holding pretty deep in apps there.
Kavik's going around.
Kavik, he'll get the kill.
Just managed to catch off Alu.
Oh, but
Norbert is down.
X7, he's going off a little bit here.
Oh, wait, Waylander catches him, though.
Waylander him out. LXCB just going straight through the smoke, but Waylander
he's
flashes
down
himself.
Already. World Edit managed to catch LXCB through the window.
Market position, but this just leaves it in a 2-on-4 for the two Ents players, Ariel and Sergey.
Sergey's managed to capture the bomb,
and Ariel's got a pretty nice position, but he hasn't really got control.
They're both on
A-side.
Full health. There isn't enough health down on the Winstrike team.
True that. This is going to be hard for Sergey to get across here.
It's going to be a hard-fought one if Winstrike don't finish them off now.
Ooh, this could be a good kill on Boomich if he was to try and come onto site, but I kind of think that gives away the entire strategy.
Moving. Ariel's definitely wary of it. Nice! Mashed his bait him out. He took quite a bit of health for that.
But it was worth it.
Definitely a necessary sacrifice.
now his position is actually more of a hindrance than it is a bonus.
Yeah.
But Sergei gets the kill there, and so does Ariel.
He's only Wayland the left, and he's just
running. Oh my god, and Sergei dies in the molly there. Ariel against Wayland. Wayland gets the headshot to finish that round off, so that means Winstrike have 13 rounds going into the second half, so ENCE are going to have to pull off a fucking miracle to make this work.
God damn, that was very close. Ariel and Sergei, they have that under control. It's going to be a hard-fought win. Their tactics, they were doing well. But it was just Waylander with that last little headshot.
Yeah, and Sergei dying to the molly there. I don't know exactly that
was
what happened.
I don't know if that was an accident or it was just pure bad luck.
Yeah.
If Sergei survived, that would have been a very different match.
Yeah, they probably would have won that because they could have peaked him together.
Definitely. But, yeah, I was going to say, that Molotov definitely caused a lot of problems because fucking Ariel's position was very good. They became more of a hindrance to him. He managed to do that nice kill up on the stairs.
Yeah.
But I think he knew Waylander was there. And it was a bit of a... It's kind of been a draw situation. However, Ariel did... He was only on, like, 45 health.
Yeah.
And then Waylander just managed to pull it off with that lucky headshot.
Yeah. That was a... That was an amazing half from Winstrike there. Mm. Not letting ENCE get anything. I think during this little break here, ENCE are going to be kicking themselves that they couldn't get more rounds there.
Mm.
They lost a lot of rounds.
They need... Well, I think them now being counter-terrorists might be the big change that they need because they were, like I said, they were sticking to main every match. They always went for the default one. They did well some bits, but they were just using it over and over again. And Winstrike clearly read that.
Yeah.
And they played well. They hold down their points, hit their targets.
Yeah. Instead of saying match, say rounds, because obviously you can see it's rounds.
Oh yeah, so this is the match and there are
yeah, the rounds in between.
Good point. What?
Well, just improve your calling a little bit.
Never.
Shut up. Out. I am the best caller in
I
the...
I don't take criticism from you.
Oh, wow. That's bullying, dude. Well, as Fred's just gone during this pause, we'll just see what the scores are. Kavik coming up big at the end there with World Edit and Boomich following pretty close behind, which is cool for them. The other two, Waylander and Norbert, didn't get a lot of kills because they were on the other side and just couldn't really get involved as much as the other players, I believe. But overall, Winstrike had a killer half, and
very proud of the Winstrike boys for managing to pull it off. Like we just said, they're gonna have to. ENCE gonna have to pull off a miracle here to make this work, and they're about to kick it off now. They're voting to start the second half. And the second half will be starting in about 15 seconds.
So, let's get this bread, boys. Okay, so, Winstrike are looking towards to go towards this B position, to go towards the B hit. This almost looks like the exact same round that Winstrike won on the CT side. And it looks like it will be like that. It's a 2v3 and ENCE should win this, but World Edit gets a nice headshot. Oh, and ENCE get the first pistol round here.
Having taken Zach's criticism very harshly, I cried for like several hours.
Yeah. But moving swiftly on into the commentating, Winstrike lose their first lose the pistol round in almost the exact same fashion as ENCE lost it. The ENCE stacked B, Winstrike pushed B, like as in ENCE pushed B last time, and they lost. It was literally a mirror round and almost with a mirror ending. So it's it was like looking in a mirror from the last round. So ENCE, Winstrike looking to go towards this A site,
Obviously, not much presence there from the Ents guys. But it looks like they might be rotating onto the A side. They're just waiting for this smoke to disperse the...
And it's moving slowly. Down. Oh!
Will it spots the gang connector. And...
See if you can knock an aerial. Norbit's down.
Alu misses his shots there.
Well, then it's down.
Sergei with a lovely little headshot with the scout there.
Ooh, only one loss with Alu.
Very
is this when we start to see Ence start pulling through?
So this will be this is when I think we truly get to see it, because Winstrike will get to do their full buy here, and I don't think Ence will do any messing about. I think they just want to win this.
Definitely, because they have had a rough start.
Yeah, like if we look how many 10 CT rounds in a row from the Winstrike boys. So. We'll have to they'll have to be careful.
So here we go, any of the round.
Ents are just actually going for some pretty aggressive control here. Sergei,
I think their aggression is what we kind of need. But this kind of more controlled aggression.
Very nice shot from Alu there. And this will probably scare.
Yeah, definitely quickly taking out Kvik.
This will scare Winstrike. So,
keeping frosty. Boom moves round.
But as we see, the Ents boys just drop back onto side.
Waylander boosts him.
So Boomich is... Oh, but Alex... Ariel's watching this position like a hawk. As soon as that smoke... Oh, the timing, dude. Oh, Boomich gets a lovely headshot there. And breaks the ladder room vent and runs away. X7 there, going for a little jump peek, but doesn't manage to spot the player. Boomich and Waylander on the...
only one loss either side.
But however, Sergei is very low.
Yeah, and Ents hasn't taken all that much health. Sergei is very low.
And Alu has seen one of the players and probably hears Boomich come in and get
He takes a heavy hit there, but Alu manages to pull through.
Alu getting two kills in this round so far, and the bomb's actually going towards the B site, and... This will be heard from X7, and the quick rotate will come through.
Oh, it's moving through.
Norbit getting a lovely little headshot there.
Ooh!
And X7 failing
missing
to
that
get
shot.
There. And Sergei just going to have to save on this one. So this might be a quick finish from the Winstrike side. They're going to be on 14 rounds out of a 16 they will need. So this might go on to be a 1-1. If that is the case, me and Fred's throats will no longer exist within this universe.
I hope one of the guys at Ents plays a cleric in Darkness. They're gonna need some fucking miracles.
Right now, truly. Because they're gonna make us commentate a third map, and you watch it goes overtime like 8 times.
Yeah.
And our throats will literally no longer exist. So... That's enough of me and Fred complaining about how our throats feel.
More commentary on that later.
More commentary on that later when our throats do no longer exist and we're speaking like, "Hello, guys!
That was a very good game, Zach." And that's all we'll say, because we want to conserve
throat energy.
We're just going to sit in dead silence until, like, one of them gets a maze code. Like, "Oh my god!" And it instantly hurts because of
our throats. So, Alu...
He's under control, gets smoked,
but
he moves out of there.
Boomich just manages to get mid control. This should push.
Example, he leaves.
Ariel taking some aggressive control of the ramp area as he's.
Sergei backing him up.
Holding his angle just in case.
Alu's going in.
He didn't see him, he was through the
other
wall.
Yeah.
Just holding the mid area.
He sees that smoke go from Waylander, blocking his vision.
So now they'll have connect control.
Yeah, Waylander's taking his time.
Boomich is going up short, and he will be flashed into the ladder position. But
Alexi being the sniper's nest,
will hear all of this going on.
Yeah, he sees the flash.
Boomich won't know he's there, but Alexi B has all of that info now to give to his teammates. So Alu will carry on holding that connector position. And he sees a foot of Waylander, and he gets the kill on Boomich.
Gets the headshot on Boomich.
And the,
almost. That,
but the two from Ramp, and oh my god, they get the, all of the kills. Alexi B, nice flick up from Alexi B to get that kill.
Sorry, Ward led, ordered it left. 2v1 and
And he's dead. The 1-2
he could have had that shot there, but he just didn't quite get it.
He didn't get quite get the last hit to kill the player, and obviously the guy on the stairs just snuck up and shot him in the head to finish him off.
Okay, it's a win from ENCE.
Another round from ENCE. It's very scrappy once again because the Winstrike boys are getting some really nice shots.
Yeah, I was gonna say they are taking heavy losses. Unlike last time where they were doing this clean, they are taking some heavy losses in this round. But nonetheless, they are indeed winning.
So, I guess it doesn't matter then, does it? But
I guess unless they've got the mindset they're prepared to take sacrifices as long as they win at the end, that might be what they're doing.
Ooh, Ariel just managing to get that kill in the
taking
underpass.
Now Waylander. Waylander, this time it's a flip though. Only Waylanders are on pistols now.
Yeah, only Winstrike is on the pistols at this current moment in time.
Waylander, Winstrike, something.
Don't worry, I'll correct you without even talking about it.
Good.
So Alexi B
no one
gets
has to know.
Kev or whatever his name is gets Kavik manages to get a lovely little dink with the Deagle there to take him out. Norbert will be taken out by Sergei there.
Kavik and World Edit.
And World Edit gets taken out, but Kavik going for a couple more kills but misses and gets swiftly taken out. So ENCE on their sixth round, which is
unlike last time, what I said, how they were prepared to take heavy losses, not happening. Only one loss this time. So ENCE are starting to pick it back up a little bit here. As we can see already from ENCE's side, their kills have jumped up a fair amount.
Alexi B again getting 16, like being the big carry for both of the matches. Not quite better than Alo on the last one, but
yeah, Alo's really getting back up there. He's not on the best form at the moment.
No,
but
if
he's getting there,
if he starts hitting some nice AWP shots, that would really help ENCE out.
Yeah, definitely.
But I think ENCE definitely heard the drop under, and Alexi B is playing a position where you can get a nice vision on the under position, but it's been smoked off, so it's going to be a quick push-up connector for the Winstrike boys. That was very two deaths from
things were equal at the moment.
Alo, okay, Sergei getting a nice kill on site, very important. Alo playing in the window position.
Waylander down.
Should get this kill. Oh no, he
just catches Alo.
So he's
on the
X7 almost catches him out there, but X7 is going for the AWP, I believe. Or just holding the mid position with an AUG. As we can see, Kavik just at the top of mid here. I don't know if he'll commit to any site or just save the weaponry. Looks like he's favouring the A site here and will push up connector.
Yeah, he's going for the move in.
So
Sergei doesn't know yet and he hasn't rotated.
Sergei,
I think he's going for X7 though. No, wait.
Sergei is currently playing the ramp position, so he will hear the plan. But and he's about to drop off and check, I believe, and he should get taken out. Sergei playing a very clever position, and X7
just
manages
to turn around the light, and just managed to turn around at the right moment. Yeah, X7 quite clearly has the AWP, handing it off to Alexi B.
Ooh, now there's two AWPs. So
yeah, Alo and Alexi B
both have AWPs now.
Sergei on the AK, Ariel X7 on the AUGs. Three pistols for Winstrike.
Yeah, this is the first Winstrike pause. I would think so as well. That round, they probably should have won it. But at the same time, it was a save, so you don't expect them to. They did a lot of damage, but as you can see, ENCE obviously had enough money to buy back into this, but we'll have to see. It's going to be very difficult for the Winstrike side if they can't.
I understand why they paused, because they had this round, but now ENCE started picking it back up, but they didn't want to lose this.
No, they want to slow down the momentum a little bit of ENCE winning, I think it was 3 rounds in a row now.
Mm.
So they've already got half.
They want to hold on as long as possible. sniper's nest completely blocked out.
Yeah, Ali was trying to get a sneaky pick over the top, and World Edit's just standing right behind that smoke, but Ali will drop off before he has any risk, and World Edit is dropping off as Aerial is pushing. And they seem to be going for an A execute here, Winstrike. Sergei holding the palace position, and everyone's setting up for the basic A smokes, so it's going to be an A execute as I called. And he's mollying, Kovic's mollying under, and they're mollying the basic positions that he's been
made.
Oh! And
Sergei's down.
Get Sergei.
Norbert's rushing in there.
Ence can't lose this round.
He's trying to get to higher ground.
Boomich drops the bomb, so
one
of his teammates
backs off.
To. Boomich just pushed through the smoke.
Alu's going easy. He's trying to get us some of those sweet orc shots.
World Edit gets this. Yep. Ence lose this round, and this puts Windstrike on match point. So this. Fuck our throats, dude. I guess that's a GG for our throats. Our throats are going to quit.
My throat current is... draw right now, but I can tell you that our throat's definitely losing.
Yep. Our throats are going to.
Heavy losses on this
heavy
round.
Heavy losses.
Ence could have pulled through it and saved our throats, but now Winstrike's like, no.
No. Winstrike's like, nah, we're actually. I chose myself for my pick'em, so I want to guarantee that.
We decided to win.
Yeah. But obviously there is still the last map, which we will check
just now, actually. The last map will be Train.
That's going to be an interesting one.
A very good map for AWPers in particular. So Alu and World Edit, the two AWPers for both teams, are going to have a lot of impact on that. And as we can see, we've seen what Alu can do. World Edit, more of a passive AWPer, but Alu can really start to take over a game with his AWP.
Definitely, I was the other CUA, he got the 4K.
Yeah.
Although in this round, World Edit has proven himself.
Yeah, like I said, he's a very good AWPer. Like, he's not super aggressive, he's not super fantastic or anything, he's just a good AWPer. Which is kind of what you need, a stable, good AWPer.
Yeah.
But when Alu is going off, he is going to destroy you.
I think one of the things that definitely has World at his side is because he's sticking to his tier. If that's the right word. He's a good AWPer, and he's just playing well with the team in general. Not that Alu doesn't, but I think his team works to, obviously, World at his side very well. Norbert goes in there.
Alu gets taken out by a very fast Norbert, but Norbert gets taken out by X7. X7 will drop back onto short, but the short position is pretty much nice flick there to get that kill. But
well, Edit could have had that, but
World Edit was going to try and kill his teammate. But this should be it. Unless Sergei can pull off a madness right now, this should be...
Unless Sergei... It turns into Jesus, then starts pulling miracles
out of literally his rectum, but I don't feel like it's gonna happen. He could get Boomich here, but he does get Boomich, but that's GG for Ents, and it will be going to a third map. So rip our throats, because it is genuinely all over for our throats.
Next match.
Okay, so I'm going to go for a Waz. We're going to take a tiny little break here for the till the next map, so see you guys in a second.
So our throats can...
Okay. So, do we want to go back to CS? I guess.
Yeah.
Why does the water smell like fucking ass, dude? Smell it. Like, smell the water.
I know what you mean already. I started drinking glugs and it was going, and I was like, something's not right here.
I know, right? Fuck. Okay, train's already up.
I was like, Katusi drinking, it's like, something's not right here.
Yeah.
What's going on?
It's normal water out the tap as well. It just smells like ass. Like, you know when you smell river water? It's what it smells like.
I think I drank river water before.
Yeah, once. Me too. It's definitely not on purpose, but...
Not on purpose. it's like when you go swimming in the sea,
yeah.
And you swallow a bit, or like swimming pool, you just swallow a bit of that salt water.
Oh, swallowing a bit of that salt water always fucking kills you. Oh, look
Bot
at
Fred.
Bot Fred.
What a lad.
Oh, look at this aim.
Look at my six skills, dude. I'm that good at CSGO.
Fred, I'm pretty sure... this is you, isn't it?
This is me. Look at my confusion.
You're so confused. Where am I? Where are the enemy? I think you're broken, Fred.
Hey, don't be mean. Okay, here we go. I'm playing. I'm gonna make it a good position. I'm moving in. So let's take a break from murdering those fuckers. I'm gonna go back around.
Oh.
Gonna catch those boys. Actually, wait. No, I'm gonna move around. No, I'm not. I'm moving back here. I'm making some good plays here.
I think you think you know where one is. Oh, have you found him?
Yeah. Got that fucker. Never mind, he wasn't there.
God
must
damn.
Have moved away before I saw him.
Oh,
wait, no, never mind. There he is. No, he's back.
Oh, no, he's...
Okay, make my way. Turning around. Trying to jump up there. Can't quite make the jump.
Fred.
It's a pretty high jump.
Fred, you're really good, man.
I am quite clearly amazing at fucking CS, dude. Look at my skill. Do you ever...
The map just joined the map. Oh dear.
CSGO, what kind of witchcraft are you trying to do here?
Oh dear.
Here we go. Bot, no, we need to. No, we didn't see the rest
okay,
of the
I'll go back to Fred.
Yeah,
Fred's
Bot
very
Fred,
lost.
Moving in there with some sick gameplay.
Very, very cool.
Just Fred, moving in Bot. There. I'm moving back around. I think I know where those fuckers are now.
Ooh.
Here we go. Going back around the train.
Nope.
I think I've worked out where they are. Just a hunch. I'm moving there quite swiftly. Keeping to cover. I see the ladder. I'm not going to go there because I'm scared.
Get stuck on the wall as you're walking past.
Never mind. I'm moving back.
Oh. You got
Peaking.
It.
And it was safe. No one's planted yet.
Oh.
Who the fuck is that?
Oh, you're following your teammate, I think. Oh, yeah, you know. You know. You found him. Oh.
Nice little one tap from me.
Fred's very confused. He's trying to shoot you through the wall. Oh, they're all dead. Oh, he's going to run away.
I'm backing up now. Pretty scared. Never mind, I'm moving around.
Okay, you've got this.
I'm going to go around the other side. I've got a plan here. Head into Ivy. I'm going to emerge from Ivy. I'm peeking the corners. I'm doing well. I'm moving in there calmly and swiftly. I think I know where those guys are now. I'm not going to go there because they might kill me. I'm going to head back round. I think they might not be there anymore. I'm going to head back round. I'm going to go to Ivy to make sure no one's planted. Take note, Zach, from a real CS player like me. I'm moving around. I'm
trying
to go back. Someone could have planted. I'm being careful. No, silencing my footsteps.
Very sneaky. Peeking the ivy position here.
It's peeking. I'm going to go back down there. Those guys might still be down there. I'm not going to go down there because that's quite scary. And I might get taken out from the corner. Moving back around.
Who coded these bots?
They seem a lot better in any other matches I'm with them.
I know, right? Why is he so confused?
Someone please set this bot straight.
Someone just end this bot's life. I guess the issue is the player can't join because obviously bot Fred's still here, so I guess that's why the game hasn't started yet, because they can't manage to get the last guy.
Someone go fuck up bot Fred.
Someone just kill bot Fred, please.
I hope this is just the match. There we go.
Oh yeah, Waylander joined.
Bot Fred had some nice plays there, got a few kills, checked out the map, made sure no one was going near the point. Fired a few cheeky shots through a wall, missed all of them, and then ran away.
Yeah. Checking both bomb sites consistently. Making sure no fuckers on them, even though you already knew where they were and ran away after shooting.
They could have moved, you know how fast these guys are, Zach. Right, when you're playing as a bot in a professional CS match, you let me know, Zach, how you know bad and scary it can get.
That in certain servers it's really funny because it will as soon as you leave the server or get kicked or like you disconnect, it will make you bot and then your name.
Mm-hmm.
So it'll be like Zach115, bot Zach115, or it'd be bot fredable.
Yeah.
When you leave, and then you're just like, haha, that's actually what you are, a bot. And everyone makes that joke, it's great.
Unless that bot gets some sick headshots. It wasn't going to, but that's...
No.
if that bot turned on its aim bot...
It is an aim bot.
It needs better aim.
Is it? Bang, 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 bang. Bang, bang.
The second I saw it, I was like, oh, I'm getting some good shots. I found the spawning place, but I was like, oh, they might have moved. Then I ran away.
Even though you could tell they were all still there.
You don't know that, Zach. Again, you don't know how professionals play. The things they can do, Zach.
Big brain.
Big. Then again, also the map joined the map.
The map joined the map, yeah. That was the most exciting moment of this. Look, map is joining
the spectators.
The map is watching itself. It's like, yeah.
Player bot friend left the game, kicked from the session. Motherfuckers.
Why would they kick such a quality player?
I know, dude, that was amazing.
Let's get down to eating lots of ass. We can actually stick on some music whilst
it breaks.
Let's just play this. What song are we gonna?
What's this one?
What's this one?
You know,
yeah, cat dog one.
Yeah,
that's what that song is.
What does that spell? Dog. I assume I was like Bot Fred being taught how to spell.
This is like Bot Fred, listen to me. This is how you aim. Dog. No, that's not how you aim. Dog. Trying to draw a dog on the wall. No, stop.
Get it, Fred. They're on the spawn. Fuck them up. No, where are you going? I'm going to check the point. You know where they were. They might be there. But they're not.
Fred, stop going. Fred's just like, yeah, I'm bored of killing them. I'm going to go check the point.
Gonna go check Ivy. Wait, no, never mind. I'm moving away.
Oh, dear.
Coming around the corner. Oh, I found them. They're taking out us at spawn. Gonna take a few two cheeky shots before leaving. That'll scare them off.
Of course, every time.
Yeah, I guess that was like Baby Bot Fred at the end of this song.
Yeah. Bot Fred.
C. Hey, what's the spell? Dog.
It's like, it would have been better if he said duck. Duck would have been way better.
Yeah, of course.
D-U-K. Now imagine, they spell out duck and he's just like, dick! It could be that easy.
But clearly Bot Fredable didn't find that easy.
No, he
it can be that easy, but it's not always.
No. No. He was using
the lightning strike, yeah. And then he went, oh fuck, and then, you know, went off somewhere.
Also, he chose to use a controller in CSGO. Big, big brain mistake.
You not play with the controller in CSGO?
What?
You not play with the controller in CSGO?
Yeah.
Also, you should do. It's all pros do. All these guys are now Zach. There's keyboards, they just shut up. Everybody just... Well, when they're also going to need without their little,
their little
NES controllers.
Controllers. Their little Game Boy Advances. That's what I've been doing all this entire time. I didn't have my Game Boy Advance,
exactly.
I didn't have my Pokemon Game Link.
Yep.
Oh, the match is about to start.
Yeah, boys.
As always, ESL admins getting involved where they shouldn't. Well, that's enough of that. Then, are you ready for some hard?
Okay, so that first one was pretty good, but Fred clearly MVP,
God,
the real MVP.
Godfred. Okay, so it's currently 1-1. Pretty interesting series so far.
Okay, so recap. First match. Winstrike did well like the first three rounds, and then ENCE fucked them up.
Just
they started to bring it back up a little bit. And Winstrike, but it wasn't enough. ENCE, you know.
No, ENCE just crushed them, and then
Winstrike brought it together for the second match, and then fucked them up most of the rounds, and started to bring it back a little bit, but it wasn't enough.
Yeah, this is the decider, of course.
Not that song. No.
No, I'm not playing it.
No, that's because you brought that song, and I was like, no, not that.
That is the decider.
That's the decider.
Yeah, Train is the decider. Okay, so yeah. Just they couldn't get anything going. ENCE just couldn't get anything going in the last match. So we're gonna have to move swiftly on into Train. And good half is what they're saying to each other. So this is going to be.
Wait, did he put a D smiley face? Whoa.
Whoa.
Lexi B. Dude,
Lexi B. Trying to flex.
If you put a winky face there, then you know.
That would have been better.
10 times better.
Just like. Well.
Good half, boys.
Good half. So, Waylander aggressively getting onto site pretty early. X7 playing this Ivy position along with Alexi B. But little do they know, they're about to be pushed and get all three kills and get the bomb. But, Waylander gets a quick kill there. But this should just be ENCE's round already. That was a very quick. Swift takedown, and really don't say.
That was amazing.
That was a really good
that was aggressive, but he was pulling off those headshots.
Alexi B, Sergei finishes it. Easy round for ENCE. Easy ENCE. So
ENCE off to a good start here.
That's what they needed after last map.
Yeah, definitely. Hopefully, from their break, they've gotten
their shit together.
Yeah,
it's definitely the word to use.
See, yeah, definitely. Now let's see how Winstrike fare.
Yeah, so
I mean, they've definitely proven themselves to be a challenging opponent, and they could do this.
Yeah, they could. I think this is why ENCE chose CT side. They're obviously superior on CT as they showed on Mirage and Dust 2. So they need to get a good start here on missing that Zeus there.
Yeah, oof.
So
that would have been a nice and easy one as well.
Yeah, really quick kill.
And then Norbitz is down and out.
Looks like they're going to be going towards his B position, but...
So like he sees him and manages to catch off Waylander.
And his teammate will just go
there
back.
There with an eagle.
Just trying to spray through the smoke a little bit. He's maybe trying to get a kill, but no one's behind the smoke, so...
Ali's waiting on Train.
Ali's waiting for Boomich to go, but Boomich is going to go down Pop Dog, maybe? But he will get taken
in the
out.
Corner.
There's already a guy down. That nade almost kills yeah. World at it.
That's probably that'd spook anyone, to be honest.
And X7 gets the kill there.
I'll say that name was spooked the fuck out of you.
Boomich dies.
Kavik's trying to fire through the box.
But no one's going to give him anything. He's going to have to peek if he wants to try and get a kill here, and he will die.
Mm-hmm.
So
especially that wall currently splattered with his blood. I think he's not looking the best right now, and he's down.
Ali yeets around the corner and kills him with the UMP. Another round for ENCE there, not losing another player.
Nope. Some nice clean rounds then.
This will be the first bye for the Winstrike side.
So
going AKs.
We'll see what they can do here. World Edit is going to have to go for the Deagle. So he can...
4 AKs, 1 Deagle.
Boomich can get punished for not having the head armor as well. Mm. As you can see, look, he doesn't have that little helmet.
Yeah.
And Alexi B.
With a headshot.
Yeah, taking him out. X7. Very good flash.
This is what I meant from the we both meant. This is some controlled aggression.
That was just it. That was the round.
Yeah.
Well done.
Those are, they've been doing it. They're playing aggressive, but not scrappy. That was clean. It was smooth. They're in control.
That was.
They're being swift about it.
Three rounds I've seen this entire series.
Mm. Next round, Winstrike better start getting their shit together now.
Well, they can't. They're gonna look at their money. They're gonna have to half buy here. They'll most likely lose this round, and this will be 4-0 for the end side. Looks like it's gonna be a fast rush B this time. Got an ENCE player playing right at the bottom. Sergei should have all of the info. That nade not doing as much as he would have hoped. Him getting the first kill. Look at all his teammates.
Look at that health drop. I don't know if you look at it.
Yeah, that was his teammate spraying them down.
Yeah.
And that's just GG. Kavik, the only one left.
That was so swift.
Yeah. Again, another clean round from ENCE.
Mm.
Four rounds.
Only one loss.
Yeah, only one player dying. Very clean round again.
Maybe our throats might make it. If the defense are quick enough, I thought it might be like, alright.
If it's a 16-0, it'd be very easy for us. But I doubt it. As we've seen, Winstrike does like to put a lot of effort in.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so we got World Edit. So now, here we go. We got World Edit on the AWP, and the rest of them on AKs.
And Alu also now has the AWP as well.
Like you said earlier, it's going to be Alu and World Edit on the AWP.
Yeah, because I have big brain and know they're both AWPers. Biggest brain. So X7 just mollying that off, so they can't push the Ivy position early. They're gonna have to wait a little bit if they want that control.
Lando.
Obviously Waylander in the A main position. So we have to see what comes of that. Ench just using some very basic control right now. Just waiting for any aggression. Waylander gets the kill on Alexi B on the blue train. Aerial playing pretty close to the hot dog position. But Aerial, a tempered aggression, perfect timing. And World Edit trying to snipe him through the wall, but he's already dropped off. He had none of those hits. Aerial going back to where he belongs in the hot dog. This is throwing a wrench into Windstrike's plans, I believe. Looks like they will be going towards this A position now. I don't know if they're going to be using some mollies and smokes.
Norbit's quite clearly using a molly.
Ooh, Ali's position could be very important here.
Ooh, Aerial's down, but Norbit took some heavy hits. Takes out
World Edit is dead. Yep. Alu. That's a kill from X7. X7 going on top of the blue train. But
no, he's not going to risk it.
Just going for info here. Norbert trying to go for a kill. And Sergei gets the kill there. And Kavik is just going to save the AWP here. Because look at the timer. He has no time left to do anything at all.
Yeah.
That round wasn't as clean from ENCE, but it's still another
win. Through in the end. Not heavy losses, though. Only two.
No, look at their money. Look at 10k, 8k, 10k. They if they lose this round, they can still go for two more. So, and as you can see, I think...
And because of their survival rate, they don't need to spend too much. They could easily drop each other if needed. I think it'll come to that, though.
Look, two guys with zero deaths, two guys with one death each, and another guy with
time
two.
Let's see what Winstrike come up with.
Yeah, Winstrike are going to have to pull a rabbit out of the hat right now if they want to get past this ENCE defense. Mm. But... We'll see.
Can be done, though.
Sure can. They're just going for a buy here. I think what's going to need to happen on the ENCE side is World Edit was going to have to try and get an entry somewhere. But even after they got the entry on Waylander, they just couldn't really capitalize on it, and he just got taken out. So I don't really know. I think they're going for some faster aggression here. Caving is being peppered with utility. Trying to get a kill. Boomage getting a very nice headshot. And X7 being taken out. Sergei also being taken out. Allo getting the kill, and so is Alexi B. This is going to be a very... They're just going to go back and save here. And aggression was apparently what the doctor ordered, because it completely destroyed the Ents' defense.
Definitely threw him off, though, Allo, you know.
Ooh, nice no-scope from Allo there.
They might be able to do this. Then again, they're on great health themselves.
Yeah.
Smoking.
Oh my god, they have this! That was a very nice come.
That was a 2v3. GG on fucking Allo. What a save.
Allo getting two very good kills there. The no-scope. Well, he got three that round. He got the no-scope, he got the kill in IV, and he gets the kill.
That's a great save. Things weren't looking good, and Winstrike could have had that, but no, Allo went in there and made sure that wasn't the case.
Alexi B and Allo just managing to close that out. They shouldn't be doing that, but as you can see... Like the money.
Take a look at the kills here.
Look at Allo going one, a bit mad.
1, 1, 2, 2, 5, 5, 5, 6, 8.
Very impressive from the ENCE side right now.
Definitely that, making a comeback and a strong one.
This has got to be very demoralizing for the Winstrike side. Mm. Just everything you do is being shut down or just basically negated by a very strong ENCE defense. ENCE defense rolls off your tongue very nicely.
ENCE defense. Defense.
And this should be some B aggression here from the Winstrike team. And Allo gets another nice shot. And he'll miss that second one. He shouldn't be doing that. But Sergei is getting the cross and he manages to get two there. And Wayland is all alone and swiftly gets taken out by Sergei. Another easy round from ENCE.
Mm.
Like, this side could just be a 15-0.
Yeah.
Like, it's just so clean. Like, and obviously the T side taking another timeout. I don't know if it's for our throats or for them to get their tactics together, but I appreciate it either way. Very, very impressive CT side from ENCE here. And... I think this is either a save or a half buy from Winstrike, unless they force into this, which could very, very well happen. And look at the ENCE, look at Winstrike's kills. One, two, one, two.
There's obviously got 6, 7, 7, 6, 8. That was very different from the last round. Eh? Equally yeah. Showing, like ENCE's jump.
Yeah, like ENCE. And
getting back into power.
Yeah, ENCE across the board just sharing every single kill. It's not like anyone is particularly playing any better than anyone else, quite clearly.
Ooh, here we go.
It's a Molly in the main position. Ivy, oh, very ooh. Nice kill from X7, getting the
GG,
boys
X7, GG.
Jumping past. X7 almost
misses
getting
that
one.
Norbit taking the corner. Just saw his leg, though.
Oh, nice kill from Norbert there and Alexi B. But now they know. X7 gets taken out. Norbert could do this for the Winstrike side. But I don't think he knows where Ariel is. And Ariel will take him out.
Oh,
this
yeah.
is a very easy shot. And Kavik gets also taken out by Ariel.
Mm-hmm.
Ariel having a very big impact in that yeah. round from his positioning.
Ariel just sat there by
the
electric
orange.
Box.
Yeah, the orange.
Just as... Norbit went there. I think he was definitely caught off guard because Norbit missed that shot. It wasn't
yeah.
that fast, so I reckon he could have done it.
Yeah, I think he was just surprised.
Yeah, definitely. That would have definitely caught him. He definitely looked
like
he'd been
caught off.
Felt like he got
yeah.
caught off guard.
Yeah, true. Obviously, that doesn't help if you're trying to hit an AWP shot. Looks like they're going for some basic A default again. Alexi, no, Ariel. X7 shooting through the wall there, tagging Norbert a little bit. the smoke coming through. Sergei holding pretty deep in the B apartments. But World Edit is having a look over the smoke. The A main position is being mollied a lot, but Waylander still manages to get the kill. X7, oof, gets one there, and now ENCE at the disadvantage. Alu is about there. Whenever you know Alu's about, it could go either way.
Mm-hmm.
And obviously the ENCE boys have control of the A main area. World Edit is just going to be holding that passive angle to make sure that he can get a swift kill if needs be. But ENCE still all over this A side, and the Winstrike side don't seem to know what they're doing right now. Oof, I didn't even see that. Lexi B gets a fantastic kill, but gets traded out very swiftly. And World Edit manages to take out Alu, who doesn't manage to fire back fast enough. Oh, Sergei gets the kill through the smoke. Oh my god! 2 and 3! No, that's insane!
Sergei, man.
Sergei, calm down, son. Getting 3 swift headshot orbs.
Not even the orb dude, but he just picks up. Like, yeah, I can fucking do this.
Yeah, hey, Alu. Who do you think you are? Have you seen me orb? And he just takes them all out.
What a fucking laugh. Jesus, dude.
Clutch in that round.
He had that was completely insane. Under his little finger. He was like, no, I fucking got this.
True, true. Man.
He just quickly picked up and slapped on his back and then did a little run.
Oh, man. Look, I don't know what you do if you win straight here.
Win.
And also, Count Terrace took a timeout to let him cool off after that fucking clutch. He's going to need it. His hand must be on fire.
He's just sat like... Calm it down, boys.
That was an insane round from Sergei there, going off.
Jesus. He just went into power mode.
I know,
that miracle that he needed in the last round, he just whipped it out right now. He's like, oh, here's my miracle.
Well, he did it when ENCE needed it. Like I said, this is looking more and more convincing from ENCE that they should take train no problems at all. Especially if players are hitting that kind of form.
It's fucking so scary. Yeah, time to turn to AWP Master Sergei.
Yeah. And Alu's going for a quick peek here. If one pushes him, he might be able to get a kill. Norbert gets legged there.
Yeah.
And they're not going to be re-peeking that angle. And X7 misses his shot.
He smokes the corner anyway.
Yeah, the tunnels are smoked off, or Ivy is smoked off, but Waylander's managed to sneak down the Olaf position.
Just gonna sneak on down there, see how shit goes.
So, Alexi B just looking down there a little bit, making sure there's no one there. He's got a sneaking suspicion, I believe, that there is a player that has managed to sneak down the train side.
Ooh, nice one from Waylander.
But... now they know his position, so he shouldn't be too much of a nuisance for much longer. X7 gets taken out of there.
He takes out Alu.
Kill through the smoke. This is all down to Sergei once again.
That's right, he takes out Lexi B, not Alu. That was nobody who took out Alu.
There's an orb in front of him. Be careful, guys.
Sergei, boy, you might need to go into orb master mode. Never mind, you don't need no orb.
Sergei, don't do this to them. This is bullying.
Well, they make sure he can't get that ult, though. It's on fucking fire.
If they give him any fights here, I think he can...
Oh, no. Kavik was sneaking around there.
I know.
Now Norbert just smashed.
He almost killed Norbert as well.
Yeah. He's on 16 health, but you just managed to quickly tap that.
Oh, dear.
First win to Winstrike, though.
First round. They need to get every round now.
Yeah.
To make it a viable CT half, in my opinion. They need to get at least the next 5 rounds, so they can get 6 rounds overall, and that would actually not be a bad half on train. But if they carry on losing, maybe if they get 3 rounds, it'll be a disappointing half for them.
Alu's taking control of the point.
I think...
Seven's to keep in the corner. Welland has been hit.
Waylander's
he's taken out swiftly by Lexi B.
After the amount of the amount of times that, he's been a really big nuisance.
It seems okay.
Ward Edit has been boosted on top of the box, and he'll be fine.
Ariel's moving in.
Ariel's just making sure.
Lexi be keeping on top of the train.
Holding that. Ooh. So, now we see what Winstrike decide to do. I think they might go towards B this round, by the looks of it. Obviously, they have the disadvantage at the moment. Ooh, so Ward Edit's managed to escape Ivy.
He's blocking off both sides.
Alu and X7 both holding him, and Alu obviously takes him out there.
Yeah.
And he won't be followed up.
Norbert rushes through. Then, yeah, I think Sergi saw him. He did. Nash just shave a bit off Kavik, but not enough. Moving around, though.
Nice Nabs kill from Sergi.
Doesn't take that much health off. It's enough that he could die. That's pretty bad, I guess, but you know.
Kavik getting slashed. Boomich getting the kill from behind, but he's not having any of it, and he gets both of those kills there.
Only one loss being Ariel.
Again, like I said, Ents not even fazed by losing that last round, and just completely take it back to how it was in every other round, dying, maybe letting one player die on their own team, and managing to keep everyone else alive. But we'll have to carry on here with the end side looking so good. It looks like it's going to be a bit of a force from the or miscommunication from Waylander and the rest of his team that whether to buy or not, unless he wanted to go for the hero AK. I don't know why you give it to Waylander of all the people on your team. But they're going for a B rush here, and we'll see. That nade never really doing as much as it should, in my opinion. Alu's holding the catwalk, or the upper position, but we'll have to see. It seems like they'll be going lower. Sergei dropping off because he doesn't want to lose his life too early, but it doesn't look like they're going to be going out very fast anyway. And they will push. Waylander's almost dead already, and Boomich getting a kill, but it's not enough, and Will's Edit's left alive and is swiftly taken out by the Ents side, getting 11 rounds. This is a very dominant CT side, and now obviously after winning they don't have a lot of money. They're going to fall by into this anyway, or force into us, I should say. Very efficient from the end side once again. This force buy from the Winstrike side is not looking so pretty, especially against an Ents that can take them so easily out on a gun buy.
It's 11-1. Things are looking great for Winstrike. Asshole.
Yeah, things are sure looking fantastic for Winstrike right now. And Alexi B will probably get
moving around the corner. He's been flashed. That's no, he's being careful. Under fire, but no. Ooh.
Waylander gets killed, but Boomich manages to trade, and Alu manages to trade that. And he sees the guy on top of the blue train, so now he has all of the info. And Alu gets a second kill onto World Edit. But we'll have to see what Norbert can do. He gets the kill Norbert's on green, down again. But he doesn't manage. And then Sergei sneaks out of the connector area and gets both of them. Now that is 12-1. Like I said a couple rounds ago, they need to win every single round from that point.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think they're going to win one.
No.
This will probably end, if not a 12-3, a 14-1. Which is devastating.
Yeah.
For the Winstrike side after having such a good mirage.
Yeah.
Where they actually crushed Ents.
Mm.
And then losing so convincingly on train, which they didn't choose to ban. Which obviously, as you can see, Ents is very good on, and Alexi managed.
Yeah.
Yep.
That's... Two down. No damage from Ence.
And yeah, they just can't do anything right now. And that's all over. That's 13-1 to the Ence side, and Winstrike not looking like themselves. Not at
all. Except for Ence definitely got that controlled aggression, which they sorely lacked.
Yeah, on the Mirage.
Yeah.
I don't...
They've got it now. They're being aggressive, but they're doing it in a very controlled manner. It's working wonders for them.
Yeah, of course. I don't know what's going on here. I think there might be a technical pause. Oh no, Windstrike has just taken a normal pause, but we can't see that. Okay.
Sick. Quick recharge. A quarter of your throat.
Yeah, I know. You can actually hear it start to go now.
Mm-hmm.
So, luckily for me, this match is going to be real fast, unless they do an insane comeback on T side. With CT side, I mean. Which... This is another full buy for the... Oh my god, look at those nades. Imagine. So they're going for a little bit of B control this time, Windstrike. Something they haven't done a lot of. Maybe trying to catch some aggression, but... As we've seen, Ents have not been aggressive on this... On the side of a map at all. Aloe and World Edit are going to get into a gunfight, into an AWP fight very quickly if he carries on peeking like this. Alu's changed position. This could be really effective. But now he knows where World Edit is, and Boomich, as you see his health, he's not going to be living much longer if anything hits him. Waylander getting tagged down to 50, only tagging back. 2 HP left on Waylander as he tries to cross back to safety. Both one hit on Boomich and Waylander. I don't know what you do here if you're Windstrike.
Oof. Through the smoke.
And he gets Waylander.
Just caught the edge in Lexi B. GG.
World Edit's gonna die here. Oh. Nope. Nice little no scope from World Edit there.
Just catches the aerial. World Edit's down.
X7. And this is.
Kvic left.
Kvic's about to be taken out here by Aerial. And that's all over for the Windstrike side. We're going into the second half with. An impenetrable wall against a weak, feeble child.
I mean, if Windstrike happened to pull out miracles, that'd be a great time to do that.
That they have to win this pistol round.
Yeah.
They cannot lose this pistol round. And if they do, it's GG. It's all over for the Windstrike side. And as much as I would love to see Windstrike make this comeback, I just don't believe it will ever happen.
Nothing's going
to
happen.
I don't think, as you could see, they're just, I don't think they're good enough on train. No. There's the map they're playing on. Because normally you would be like, ah, look, they've put up like 5 rounds. Like, they had a struggle, but I think they can do it.
Mm-hmm.
If they can't do it on T side, how the hell are they going to do it on CT side against a team that's hitting all of their shots? No question.
Unless they pull out miracles. Unless they literally start working witchcraft right then and there, then you know.
Yeah. True that. So we're just having a quick halftime break here. The Counter-Strike TV guys having a fun time right now.
Having a gay old time. If only they could form like a little pentagram with their little laser sights.
That would be awesome. But the thing is, they can't see those laser sights, sadly.
They should try at least. Have the camera guy describe it to them, to like a little to the left a bit more. Right. Since a boom. Perfect.
Look, he is the camera now. I am the camera now.
I am the camera.
I remember yesterday they were doing that. I think they're getting some shots set up.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they might be just testing some shots out. In between the break.
but
currently 262,000 people watching. He's doing it with all the cameras. Oh, it cut to the other camera.
Magic.
And now we're just looking at their spawn in black and white. Little bit of a lag there. I don't know if there's a little bit of a technical pause going on.
No, we're just on break still. And the game's about to resume. Yeah, okay. Well. Well, as I slowly die. Good half, have fun. Yikes. Have fun. Good half, have fun. Have fun.
Doesn't look so fun.
No, not for the Winstrike side. For Ents, it looks like it's the greatest time of their lives. And it just looks like they're going for an A execute or an A aggression here.
Okay, well, let's take in space. Oh, they've all gone. Yeah, like I said, they always group up with pistols. And Ents are good at that, and he's just letting them slip past him. He's cornered.
But, wait. What did he do here? Managing to get a couple kills. But Ariel causing a lot of issues, getting two, but
Sergei's
left, but we've seen what he can do with an AWP. Maybe he can replicate it with a block. And he does manage to get one. But he doesn't manage to finish off Boomich, and now this is the long road to a comeback if they want to go and go for that.
Well, he said they had to win that pistol round, which they did. Now's their chance. He just seized the day.
No,
not even seize. He just like fall and tackle it to the ground and then dog pile over it so it doesn't escape.
Carpe diem. Seize the day.
Yeah.
That's, by the way, that is Latin to seize
the
day.
Yeah, I've heard it.
Carpe diem. Yeah. That's what they have to do right now. They need to carpe diem in that girl's DMs right now. Let's go get right into it.
Honestly, I wouldn't be DMing girls right now. Now's not a great time.
Are you sure?
Maybe. It might make you feel better.
Yeah.
So Boom came in there.
Boomich and Norbert. Two nice headshots.
Wow.
He's had enough. He's had enough of this being bullied. And well, that it finishes Aloe off there. But all that matters is actually this round.
I think that's one of the disadvantages of the Ents, because they like to group up, which worked well, but this time, you know, as we could see, he just wasn't having it.
No, he's had enough. But this is where it really matters. This is where Winstrike need to prove themselves, because this is the buy round. The pistol rounds, they don't matter.
Mm-hmm.
When it comes to the buy rounds, these are the ones you need to start winning. And if Ents win this one, it's going to be a big yikes.
Ents
if you're
going
a
full AK.
If you're a Winstrike fan right now. Well, they're going for the push and he gets Sergei, but he does lose half his health for the trade. But very nice advantage got from Winstrike there.
Mm-hmm.
World Edit being rewarded for his aggression.
Yeah, he was going to peek the corner.
Looks like Ents are going for some standard control here. Alu just holding the pot dog position to make sure there isn't any aggression going on. Shooting through the wood to see if there's anyone holding close, but there wasn't. Looks like they're going to be going for a B execute here. This is going to be a difficult one.
So it's working off that way. You see it? Ooh, that was a nice catch, but he was taken out already.
It's traded.
They two down though.
They're gonna have to. Alexi B's gonna have to go big here. His teammate's low as hell. And he gets flashed. Ariel getting one kill. Oof, he almost gets the second, but World Edit survives on 1 HP, and they manage to close out the round. The comeback begins.
Here we go, boys. Winstrike, they're not having this. They are proving that if they're going to go out, they're going to go out fighting.
They're going to go out kicking, screaming,
and anything else to get out of this situation, because there is no other way they can just let this happen. They proved themselves on Mirage. They're not going to let... They're just... Everything they've done so far in this competition be undone by Ence.
And they are definitely proving it to be.
Well, we have
they're trying to whip out the miracles now.
But I still don't think they can do it. I think it's just too advantage for Ence. Ence getting one kill with these pistols, and we know how that can escalate from what we've seen them do before with these pistols.
Yeah.
Norbert managing to flank this player. Norbert getting three quick headshots.
Okay,
there.
Norbert.
Norbert, calm down, son. Norbert might be taken out here.
Oh, no, never mind. He throws a frag.
Norbert gets 4K.
Norbert, boy, I know you are losing quite badly. You don't need to get that angry.
He has currently just got back to a 1KD after those kills. Very nice play from Norbert there. But Ents probably aren't even fazed by this. If I was Ents right now, we'd just be like, keep it calm, boys. Remember, we still have another 10 rounds that we can win any of them. So, if you're Ents, you shouldn't be worrying about this. If you're Winstrike, you've got to pull miracles out of your rectum every round, because every round is a miracle. Boomich throwing a nade up there. Alexi B returning with a molly. And it might actually expand to him.
No, not quite. Just managed to defuse that there. Oh, no, never mind. He wasn't looking.
Boomich,
but Boomich pulls it off, though. But only Boomich, on 5 health. Only just, but he did it. He did it.
He did manage to do it. World edit on top of the train.
Boomich. He's moving up.
He snuck up. He just misses the player. It's Sergey. He sees him. Oh no, this could be it. Alu gets a quick kill on Waylander, but they don't know about this Boomich position.
He's waiting.
Alu is taken out by World Edit. This could be two, but he only gets one. But now Sergey is stuck between a rock and a hard place, but he does only need to hit one bullet.
Oh, he's throwing a nade out there. Moving out. Oh,
he gets one kill. On Kavik, almost gets the second on Norbert. But Ariel does. Now Boomich is going for the full flank here. World Edit tries to go for the peak of the orb, and he does manage to get the kill. Very, very, very good positioning from Boomich there. I think he caused a lot more issues than even before. He might have
definitely forced Sergey into a hard place.
Into a place that
he didn't have many options there. Which again, good play from Boomich, especially being only on 5 health.
Yeah, he had to do something, right?
He has to do something. That was a big old risk, but he pulled through in the end. It worked out well.
Yeah, he really did. Good play from him.
And the boy Boomich going in there, already incinerating, blocking off that area. Waylander's holding down Ivy. He's gonna throw a nade. X7's moving round.
X7, all he needs is a headshot here to get that kill. He's playing very close to the smoke. Waylander expects it, and X7's timing is not good.
Ooh!
And he gets Sergey with a very confident pick there. Kavik gets taken out by Ariel.
Yeah, he was only on 5 health though.
He
just needs to get
over.
Gently tapped.
And that's
like so.
Waylander gets taken out from Alexi B with the
16 health though.
Almost gets killed through the wall by the orc.
Yeah,
there.
Almost. Oh, you know, yeah. Waylander knows.
And I'm gonna see the push up from Boomich here, and he will take him out. It's another round from Windstrike. They managed to get half of the rounds that Ents currently have. And the long and arduous path is they're still stepping down it. They're like, we will step down this path. This is our path. We will take it. But as I said, Ents, they might have lost a couple. Well, how many rounds in a row? 7 in a row right now.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's 7 in a row. They won all the pistol matches from upwards.
But it just takes one round
for... Oh, was there a technical pause? Nope, no, it's just tactical. It just takes one mistake from ENCE.
Mm-hmm.
Or one mistake from Winstrike for them to take this game. So I'm going to have to let you carry on casting and like wise myself.
Swanky.
Keep the tempo high. Bro.
Yeah, well, okay, here we go. And the round has started, and it's moving off. They only need one round, but they're only making too many mistakes, though, because Winstrike are clearly proving that they are clearly strong enough to be able to take this. So Moose throws an A. Seven's emerging out. Aerial emerges out confidently. Gets taken out immediately. Boomich is down though. X7 takes him out. Kavik, staying on site, backs off from the net. Ooh. Kavik's always tight position. He's forcing him into. No, wait, no, not yet. XCV can't see him, but he's on such low health and Norbert's down. X7 here. Can't leave either point. Oh, and Kavik is taken out by Lexi B. XCV's down. Well, then it's down. Waylander versus Alu, Sergi, and all.
And take the 15th. So they're on match point. One more round will give them the match. And that must be demoralizing for Winstrike right now. Look at Fingy's money.
Especially the current streak.
Yeah. Just getting taken out on a gun round. I don't know exactly what happened, but I...
It was a tight one.
Was it?
Yeah.
But ENCE managed to keep three players alive there.
Yeah, they managed to do it. It did get quite sticky, a bit of a very... It all happened right near the bomb site, so...
Yeah.
It was quite a tight one. Winstrike could have fallen through, but ENCE just managed to push forward and show their aggression.
As I've been mentioning this entire time, ENCE's, well, top fragger currently, Sergei, is their star player, and he's been showing it, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
Especially with that clutch earlier, and I don't know what he did in that round, but yeah. I'm pretty sure he had some impact. And Aerial not too far behind, and then Alexi B, Alu. I just realised X7.
Awesome. Wait, I think Sergei's on 21 kills. He's in the lead,
yeah,
that boy.
He is the best guy in the server right now. Playing his heart out.
We're gonna get that cheeky shot.
Alu's trying to get that first shot onto Wall of
Dead. Is someone's gonna go around? Timing.
No! Alu! Why did you do that?
He looked away. He was heading right towards him. He just moved at the last bow and then fucking world dead it, dude.
Like, obviously, I know he can't see him. Like, that's obvious. Waylander, genius position here.
They're not going for it.
I think they might know. Yeah, they know. Waylander managed to kill him anyway. Through the flash.
X7 quickly to take care of him.
So Sergei might be able to get this kill on Norbert here if he manages to sneak out, but Kavik is obviously, and Norbert takes the other guy out. So that's a, unless X7 can pull a miracle out of his ass, that's not happening. So still match point for ENCE, but
Winstrike aren't, they're not done yet, no.
Not done yet, they're going to keep on taking it to as far as they can. This will be a save from
They are going to fight to the very end, and they're clearly proving it.
Yep.
Yeah, this isn't going to be so easy for ENCE.
Not at all. It would be a very difficult...
Although, I wouldn't be too worried. I would start, you know, trying to tighten them a bit more, because they don't want to leave too many mistakes now.
Yeah, in my opinion...
Don't want to be phased, but don't want to be playing with too much ease like we've got this, because they don't want, you know, to let Winstrike just run away with this. Because if they can, Winstrike clearly will.
Of course. It's like any team in a difficult position. Yeah. These are all pro players.
Kavik takes another. Ooh.
Kavik was on by Alu, and that's all she spoke. And that was a pistol round, so you expect them Winstrike to win those. Like, they didn't even buy in that hard if you're looking at the ENCE side. But we'll have to see. Alexi B electing to go for the Mac 10 here.
Mm.
Interesting choice.
Well, then and Waylander on the op. Two orgs, one AK.
Alu going for the AWP here. And one Mac 10 for Alexi B, so I assume that's going to be a lot of aggression. Alexi B's just charging right through, but Waylander manages to no scope him, but he gets caught in the corner, and that was all she wrote. And well, that it missing an easy shot there. Wouldn't normally see him missing those.
No.
Alu needs to get some impact with that AWP right now, because he. Nice Ariel, kill from Ariel. Nice. Alu needs, like I said, Alu needs to get something done with that AWP.
He's moving in there. He's been flashed.
Doesn't see the guy on site. Okay, Vic's gonna pull right into Alu's crosshair, and Alu will take him out. Now World Edit is holding green train position, but Norbert is in the connector to come and back him up. It's gonna be interesting to see what.
Where the hell's Ariel hanging out?
Ivy position.
Yeah, there he is. Sorry. Oh, is World Edit gonna move around? Oh, he is. So is Ariel though. He's gonna back up into Jeez, World Edit.
World Edit manages to flick round onto him.
Now, oh, I thought Ariel had that. It's okay though.
Alu doesn't know. Well, everyone's back of B, so. Oh, he can kill him with this nade. And he does. He runs right back into the nade. If he. Oh my god, this is gonna be really close. Why has he got his AWP out? Oh no. Oh no. No, plant. I think he just has the plant here. He does. And.
Oh, Alu misses that! Norbit, he doesn't even take damage. He completely. It wasn't just a missed shot that took damage, it could not even hit him.
It was just a whiff. Alu whiffs that. He could have finished the entire game there as we speak.
No, Norbit would not hold. Norbit is one lucky motherfucker.
I know. Alu normally doesn't miss shots like that, but today. Yeah,
no, it's like. Yeah, it's not even like the kind of miss where it took off half his health, but not the rest of that. As in, yeah, not a scratch.
Not even a scratch.
Norbit just fucking Matrix dodged that thing and then knocked him.
I don't know why Alu was whiffed that so hard. Maybe he's nervous. I don't know.
I know. I mean, understandable. It's getting to the point where let's not be phased and we've got this to...
Yeah.
We should probably start taking these guys more seriously.
That's very unlucky. Normally that would hit from that position. X7 gets taken out by Boomich also.
Wait, around the corner?
Boomich might get caught out here and he does get caught out. But
ever,
Kavik, gets taken out here.
We know how these down to 9 health though.
We know how these can end for the Winstrike side. They're gonna have to be very careful here. Ariel causing a lot of issues.
Oh my god,
Winstrike could lose this. No, they don't. That got very scary for a second.
Yeah, no, I mean, he was on 9 health, though. So all he needs to do is at least just tap him a few times and boom.
Yeah. I think, Boomich had the defuse kit, so it would have been okay. I don't know.
Like, yeah, clearly being CT was the change Winstrike needed to start picking up their game.
Some might say the wind has changed, like, their fortunes. I forced that really hard.
Worth it.
It was so worth it.
I'm not even going to regret. I'm not even going to feel bad. Just gonna sit there.
Keep it going. Well, I think Winstrike. I don't think they respect my throat. Fred.
No. You were like, Ence, thank you for saying my throat. And Winstrike were like, lol, no.
What do you think? What do you think? I like your throat or something? Disgusting.
That's just heavily biased.
Yeah.
It's just being too biased in this commentary match.
Wow.
Okay. Boom, there in his usual spot. Kavik moving round.
Setting up for the upper position.
Sergei's where's... Okay, he's going to move out there. Kavik's just down there, though. Has his eyes on him. No,
Really expect this position, though. Sergei just manages to take him out. But Norbert coming back with two.
Corner. Alu.
Alu holding back. Stop sign area.
Oh!
Doesn't hit.
He's revealed his spot, so he has to yeet out of there.
This is a difficult position if you're Winstrike, if you're ENCE right now. Because really need an entry to make this work, and you don't have the bomb.
Mm-hmm.
And I can't see anyone on that orange train. X7's going to have to go beast mode if he wants, if they're going to come out there. All coming together, World Edit gets one of them.
You see, now you know where they are.
Ho gets one, but this is all she wrote, and he's going to be right out of there. Saving his little butt. Saving his AWP. His expensive weapon. And now they only have three more rounds before it goes to overtime. Yikes. This is a game. Alu's not having any of it.
Not happy.
Not happy after he missed that shot that could have won him the game.
Yeah, not a happy Alu.
Not a happy Alu. Look at his face anyway. Look at his face. He's unhappy in his picture. So, imagine
the picture reflects how he feels right now, probably.
Yeah. I wonder if we can see Alu on the stream. That would be very nice. Show Alu's face. Show his face. Oh, we don't get to see Alu. Alu's on the other side. Looks like we're going to be getting into this very shortly. Well, let's get back into it. So this is very close now. ENCE just need one round, and Winstrike just need three. But Ariel's managed to sneak out there, I believe. Or well, no, Alexi B has.
Oh no, they're not going down there.
Alexi B is getting burned alive. And
he's taken out quickly.
Boomich gets the elbow.
TV's out there, boy.
Oh, they haven't protected the B site, and they're already out. The ENCE side, I didn't realise that. And now ENCE have control of the B site. And have really good positions as well.
Oh, no.
Or that it doesn't quite...
Oh, never mind. Takes out Sergei.
If I was Sergei, I wouldn't really peek that.
Yeah.
Alu needs to go big here.
Now they've cornered him.
Alu needs to go big. And he doesn't even check World Edit's position. Very poor from Alu there. Info not being given, obviously.
Yeah.
This must be getting pretty heated in the... what's it called? In both of the booths, like the stress most much. Imagine that, you're getting so close to that overtime.
Yeah.
And also... You're so close to being, you know, but you just want to win this game. This could be where they just step it up, ENCE, and they feel the pressure enough that they're like, well, let's stop messing about. But also, it's the same for... Same can be said for Winstrike. Boomich goes back onto site, completely giving up the pop dog position. All the players are out, and they get first two kills, three kills, and Norbert's being burned alive, and he's backside, and he will be taken out by Alexi P. This could be all over. World Edit's going to have to pull a fucking miracle out of his ass to win this one.
He's going to bat as well.
And the bomb's down. And that's it. That's ENCE win 2-1. It was a very hard-fought game for both teams there. And
you definitely, yeah, like I said before, at the first half you're like, oh, Winstrike need to pull a miracle out. They did it though.
Yeah.
GG to them.
They pulled a miracle that wasn't quite good enough out of their ass.
Wasn't quite good enough, especially that last one. I was like, oof.
Yeah, that last round, the aggression from ENCE just overwhelming the side of Winstrike.
Yeah.
Well, me and Fred are gonna go take a break, let our throats no longer be ending themselves. And we will see you guys in about 10 minutes, 20 minutes.
Oh my god. Can we mute the stream?